Namaskar, Swagatam, Suswagatam.
A gracious welcome to all of you.
GHR Career Connect and Tantra Shikshan Sanchanala Yancha Sayukta Vidyamani Ayojit Swapna Tumche Margadarshan Amche Ya Karyakramat Ami Raisoni Parivara Tarfe Me Pradyapak Milin Khanapurkar
Me Kaushal Khatri
Aplya Sarvanche Manapurvak Swagat Karto Apan Sarvani Atsa अमूल्य वे आम्हाला दिल्याबद्दल आम्ही आपले सदैव ऋणी राहू. मी आशा करतो की आपल्या सर्वांना चांगली व उपयुक्त माहिती देण्यास आम्ही यशस्वी होऊ. मित्रांनो, रायसोनी शैक्षणिक समूहातर्फे आपल्या पुणे शहरातील नगर रोडवर स्थित वाघोली या गावामध्ये विस्तीर्ण परिसरात दोन अभियांत्रिकी महाविद्यालय गेल्या 10 वर्षापासून कार्यरत आहेत. यापैकी एका महाविद्यालयाला 2016 साली विद्यापीठ अनुदान आयोग म्हणजे युनिव्हर्सिटी ग्रँड कमिशन UGC तर्फे स्वायत्त महाविद्यालयाचा दर्जा मिळाला व दुसऱ्या महाविद्यालयाला नॅक संस्थेतर्फे या वर्षी A+ मानांकन मिळालेले आहे. आम्ही शैक्षणिक दर्जा उंचावण्याकरता अभियांत्रिकी शिक्षण पद्धतीत बरेच बदल केलेत. जसं आम्ही 1 semester इंडस्ट्री एंट्रन्शिप अभ्यासक्रमात आणला. वी हॅव इन्वॉल्व्ड इंडस्ट्री पर्सन्स इन करिक्युलम डिझाईन अँड करिक्युलम रिव्हिजन. वी आर द पायनियर्स इन ब्रिंगिंग ऍक्टिव्हिटी बेस्ड लर्निंग अँड प्रोजेक्ट बेस्ड लर्निंग. आमच्या महाविद्यालयामध्ये परीक्षानंतर 8 दिवसाच्या आत सर्व निकाल आम्ही लावतो आणि सर्वात महत्त्वाचं म्हणजे टीचिंग लर्निंग अँड इव्हॅल्युएशन प्रोसेसमध्ये आम्ही पारदर्शकता आणण्याचा प्रयत्न केला. या सर्व ज्या मी एफर्ट्स घेतले त्या सर्व अमूलाग्र बदलांचे फळे आम्हाला व आमच्या विद्यार्थ्यांना आता मिळत आहे. आमचे विद्यार्थी करिअरच्या सर्व क्षेत्रामध्ये प्राविण्यासह समोर जात आहे.
हमारी परंपरागत भारतीय संस्कृति के अनुसार हम हर शुभ कार्य की शुरुआत माँ सरस्वती की वंदना से करते हैं. मैं अतिथिगण से निवेदन करती हूँ कि वे दीप प्रज्वलन कर माँ सरस्वती को नमन करें व मंच पर अपना स्थान ग्रहण करें. मैं महाविद्यालय के विश्वस्त निर्देशक श्री अजीत जी पाटिया, श्री श्रेयस रायसोनी, श्री आदित्य भंडारी, डॉक्टर प्रीति बजाज, डॉक्टर खराड़कर तथा डॉक्टर पालीवाल से अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वे अतिथिगण की सहायता करें. मैं कविता जोशी मैम से सरस्वती वंदना के लिए निवेदन करती हूँ.
तुषार हार धवला या शुभ्र वस्त्रावृता या वीणा वर दंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या शुभ्रवस्त्रावृता या वीणा वर दंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृति फिर देवे सदा वंदिता सामांपातु सरस्वती सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाया Thank you.
let us put hand together for all the dignitaries on the dais. Thank you very much. We are honored and take great pride in having distinguished panel of luminaries for today's function. I am very much glad to inform you that our young, dynamic and illustrative executive director of Raisoni Group of Institutions, Sri Shreyas Raisoni, is amongst us to grace the occasion. We welcome you, sir, to Sapna Tumche, Margadarshan Amche program. We are privileged to have with us illustrious personality who is source of inspiration for all of us, the pillar of strength of Raisoni Group of Institution, Honorable Sri Ajit Tatiya sir, Trustee Director of RGI at Pune. We welcome you, sir, to Swapna Tumche, Margadarshan Amche program. Welcome to Raisoni Career Connect.
Dosto, aap sabhi ne sapna dekha hoga IIT, IISc, NIT, COEP mein padhne ka. Aapke man mein in sansthanon ke bare mein kai prashn honge. आपके इन्हीं सभी प्रश्नों का उत्तर देने के लिए हमने इन संस्थानों के प्रख्यात अध्यापकों को आज यहां आमंत्रित किया है।
प्रथमतः मैं हम सभी की तरफ से भारतीय सूचना प्रौद्योगिकी संस्थान नागपुर के निर्देशक डॉ. ओजी काकड़े का स्वागत करता हूं। नागपुर का भारतीय सूचना प्रौद्योगिकी संस्थान आईटी सेक्टर के प्रसिद्ध टाटा कंसल्टेंसी सर्विसेज यानी TCS कंपनी और मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट MHRD का संयुक्त अभियान है। डॉक्टर ओजी काकड़े संगणक तथा सूचना के क्षेत्र में गुणवत्ता एवं मापदंड के लिए प्रसिद्ध है। मैं श्री अजीत ताटिया सर से निवेदन करता हूं कि वे तुलसी रोपे तथा स्मृति मानचिन्ह देकर डॉक्टर काकड़े जी का स्वागत करें। सर आपका स्वागत है। हम अपने आप को भाग्यशाली महसूस कर रहे हैं कि स्वायत्तता अर्थात एटोनॉमी के विषय में अभिरुचि रखने वाले आपके अपने पुणे शहर के प्रसिद्ध कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग पुणे के निदेशक डॉक्टर बीबी आहूजा सर आज हमारे सबके बीच में सभी के मार्गदर्शन के लिए यहाँ उपस्थित है। मैं पुनः श्री अजीत ताटिया सर से निवेदन करता हूँ कि वे तुलसी रोपे तथा स्मृति मानचिन्ह देकर डॉक्टर बीबी आहूजा सर का स्वागत करें। सर आपका स्वागत है। मित्रांनो, आपल्या पॅनलचे तिसरे सदस्य आहेत नागपूर येथील विश्वेश्वरय्या अभियांत्रिकी या अभिमत संस्थेचे निर्देशक आदरणीय डॉक्टर पडोळे सर। मी श्री श्रेयस रायसोनी सरांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी डॉक्टर प्रमोद पडोळे सरांचे तुलसी रोपे आणि स्मृती मानचिन्ह देऊन स्वागत करावे। सर आमच्या सर्वांतर्फे आपले मनपूर्वक स्वागत। अभियांत्रिकीचे शिक्षण हे औद्योगिक संस्थानांशी निगडीत आहे हे लक्षात ठेवून आम्ही आपल्या पॅनलमध्ये L&T या प्रसिद्ध कंपनीचे परियोजना संचालक डॉक्टर हरी ईश्वरन अय्यर सर यांना समुपदेशनासाठी आमंत्रित केले आहे। आय अगेन रिक्वेस्ट श्री श्रेयस रायसोनी सर टू वेलकम डॉक्टर हरी ईश्वरन सर विथ अ सॅपलिंग अँड अ मेमेंटो। We welcome you, sir.
Heartily welcome to Dr. Preeti Bajaj, Director of Flagship Institutes of G.H. Raisoni College of Engineering, Nagpur, which is ranked by NRIF. I'm Mr. Aditya Bhandari, Executive Director, Global Education Limited. We also welcome other directors of Risonic Groups, CA Nitilesh Sakaleja sir and Mr. Ashwin Pandey sir, Principal of GHR IT, Dr. R. D. Kharadkar, and Principal of GHR CEM, Dr. K. K. Paliwal.
आता आपण ओपन हाऊस स्वप्न तुमचे मार्गदर्शन आमचे या कार्यक्रमाला सुरुवात करूया.
Dear parents and student aspirants, today's event has been organized with a motto to guide you all to a magnificent future in the field of engineering. All of you must be anxious to listen to words of wisdom and advice from expert members of the panel. Each panelist will speak for 5 to 7 minutes. And then we will have open house discussion wherein you can ask queries to the dignitaries regarding your areas of concern. To start with the program, let us put our hand together for our energetic executive director, representative of current young generation, Shri Shreyas Rai Soni, to introduce you all to Swapna Tumche Margadarshan Amche with his opening remarks. Sir, please.
Respected board members, principals, aspiring students, and dear parents. It gives me immense pleasure to extend my very warm welcome to all of you present here on behalf of the entire Risonic Group. I would also like to express our gratitude to our esteemed panelists who have accepted our invitation to preside over GHR Career Connect. Risonic Group of Institutions, established in 1998, has completed 20 plus glorious years in providing quality education as well as exposure to its students in different fields. We have been known as trendsetters of the education fraternity. Our colleges have been ranked by NRF, accredited by NAC and NBA, and also been proud recipient of several World Bank grants. Our Pune campus aims at striking the perfect balance by providing industry-connected academics as well as top-notch sports facility with the aim to enhance the students' college experience. We have been conducting open houses every year to help the students and guide them in making the best career choices. Every topic chosen is in the best interest of the students present over here. Today's topics include career options, which will include viewpoints of different experts on career opportunities and motivation through real-life examples. Guidance for the upcoming registration process for admission in the engineering institutes will be given by the experts. We also touch upon the benefits of autonomous institutes, followed up with a question and answer session with our panel members. We conclude the session by felicitating the toppers of Pune City and celebrate their success with the entire city. As a gesture of appreciation, Risonic Group of Institutions is also extending merit scholarship to the meritorious students. We will ensure to display all the key details on its official website for quick and easy access to all the significant aspects of the seminar. I expect that the seminar will be productive and the next couple of hours will be worth your time. With this, I welcome you all to GHR Career Connect. Swapna Tumche, Margdarshan Amche. Thank you.
Thank you, Shreya sir. Today's panel of speakers have experts who are towering personalities and have many achievements to their credits. I will try to do the justice with their extraordinary performance by pointing out few of the highlights of their outstanding achievements to the house. I hope panel of experts will pardon me if I miss mentioning any of their outstanding achievement to the august house. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, our today's first speaker is renowned academician Dr. O. G. Kakde. Dr. O. G. Kakde sir is graduated from VNIT and thereafter obtained his doctoral degree from same institute. He has worked in various capacities such as Dean R&D VNIT Nagpur, Director VJTI Mumbai, and he is presently working as Director IIIT Nagpur. Beside this, 6 doctoral scholars have completed their research under him and 2 are in process. He has over 100 plus research contributions in the form of papers, articles and keynotes, etc. He has written 6 books in the field of computer science, specifically in the area of compiler design, C programming, data structures and algorithms. He is associated with Risonic Group of Institutions
in various capacities over the period of more than a decade. He has worked as expert member on various government committees like National Board of Accreditation, All India Council for Technical Education, and Directorate of Technical Education, Government of Maharashtra. He is very much instrumental in bringing reforms in the engineering education. And on the he is on advisory to many institutes and universities. He is expert evaluator in the quality assessment process of National Board of Accreditation with outcome-based education according to Washington Accord. He is also on the academic council of both the autonomous colleges of Raisoni Group of Institutions, that is GHRCE Nagpur and GHRCEM Pune. It's my privilege to call upon podium Dr. O.G. Kakde sir. I request him to kindly explain the audience about his experience in the current trends in computer information sciences and engineering education. Sir, please.
So good evening, everybody. Dignitaries on the dais of the dais, parents, and dear engineering aspirants, I welcome you to function. स्वप्न तुमचे मार्गदर्शन आमचे. I will begin with why engineering. Based on my little experience of over more than 30 years, I can say that engineering is a good career option because it helps you in developing critical thinking, analytical capabilities, which is very much required in today's industry. So it features a good employment and therefore in long run brings financial stability that everybody must be looking for. Now if you look at the employment landscape today, all of you must have witnessed how the technology has changed our lifestyle, the way we live, the way we transact the businesses. Technological advancement has changed the way we communicate, has changed the healthcare, communication, everything. And these changes we could witness especially post-liberalization. So it has changed everything. And therefore, it is changing patterns of consumption, production, as well as employment. Now, as on today, we are at the beginning of what we call as fourth industrial revolution, which we normally call as Industry 4.0, which is characterized by fusion of technologies, blurring the lines between physical, digital, and biological world. And this is going to have a huge impact. Everything is going to be smart, starting from homes, farms, cities, everything. And it definitely will lay a foundation of all encompassing and comprehensive revolution. And its effect on the employment is, it will lead to major displacement of the workforce. According to the World Economic Forum's report, Future of Jobs 2018, half of the Indian workforce requires reskilling or upskilling by 2022. So there will be major displacement on one hand, but there will be large opportunities on other hands. And large number of opportunities will be created in computer, mathematical families with the advent of technologies. All of you must have heard these buzzwords like AI, machine learning, IoT based stuff, data analytics. So these technologies are going to bring a lot of opportunities in mathematical and computer families. Now the question that arises is whether our education system is prepared to cope up with these challenges or the changing scenario. If you take a larger picture, the picture is not that rosy. But yes, we have made a beginning, and the solution lies in implementation of what we call as outcome-based education, which many institutions in our country have started implementing in letters as well as spirit. Actually, the genesis of this OBE is response, American response to societal and political pressure of 1960 and 70. The Americans were taken by surprise when Soviet Union launched Sputnik in 1957, and it has led to basically soul searching about their education system because they wanted to regain their technological superiority. So what this outcome-based education is all about, I will just brief you about that. Outcome-based education is different from what we were doing up till now or the earlier dispensation in only one aspect. Our focus in OBE is ensuring learning of an average student getting admitted into our system. And for that, what we say that you first decide what knowledge, what skills, what competencies you need to develop and work everything backward. So, follow a backward design process as far as curriculum design is concerned. Change your assessment parameters accordingly. Do the assessment. And if you find that you're not living up to the expectations, then take corrective actions. It's a cyclic process. So implementation of OBE requires constant review, taking corrective actions well in time. So here, my experience says that the institutions which are autonomous are well geared up or well equipped because of the freedom and the flexibility that they are having. They are having flexibility of designing their curriculum. So while designing curriculum, they can design a curriculum focusing on what knowledge is required to be, what knowledge, skills and competencies are required to be developed. They can put certain mechanisms in place because of the flexibility, like they can have their own academic calendar. So they can put some mechanisms in place like summer internships for the students, or full semester internships, which helps in developing certain professional skills amongst our students, which to some extent is difficult in non-autonomous institutions. Of course, many people criticize these autonomous institutions that many a times they manipulate their results. But this is not true. Because if they do this, they will be basically playing with their reputation in the job market. And nobody would like to do that. Because in a job market, either perform or perish. So, I will conclude with my advice to the engineering aspirants that choose that institution which ensures development of required skills and competencies, which will make you employable 4 years down the line. Otherwise, what will happen? You will end up with no job. So even though I said there are lot many opportunities which will be offering, jobs will not be easy to come by. Unless you are in a position to demonstrate what you can do, you won't be getting jobs. So my advice to all engineering aspirants is, make a right choice of the institution and be prepared to spend your 4 years productively. You will have a wonderful career ahead of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Ek mahatvachi suchana vaja vinanti. Manchavar upasthit sarva manyavaranchi vichar aiklyanantar apan upasthit विद्यार्थी आणि त्यांचे पालक यांच्याकडून प्रश्न घेणार आहोत ज्याला मान्यवर उत्तर देतील तर मी कृपया सर्वांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आपले प्रश्न तयार ठेवावेत नुकतेच आपल्याला मंचावर जॉईन झालेले डॉक्टर आदित्य अभ्यंकर सर यांचे आपण स्वागत करू. मित्रांनो, सर्वांना माहीत आहे की पुणे हे शिक्षण क्षेत्र म्हणजे विद्येचेच माहेरघर समजले जाते. आपल्या पुण्याच्या सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे विद्यापीठाच्या अभियांत्रिकी विभागाचे अधिष्ठाता डॉक्टर आदित्य अभ्यंकर आपल्याला अभियांत्रिकी शिक्षणाशी संबंधित नवनवीन कल्पना, जसे आंतरविभागीय अभियांत्रिकी शिक्षण व नोकरी संबंधित माहिती देतील. आय रिक्वेस्ट श्री श्रेयस रायसुनी सर टू वेलकम डॉक्टर आदित्य अभ्यंकर विथ अ सॅपलिंग अँड मेमेंटो. प्लीज पुट युअर हँड्स टुगेदर फॉर डॉक्टर आदित्य अभ्यंकर सर. सर, आमच्या सर्वांतर्फे आपले स्वागत आहे. Proceeding further, our next speaker is from our own city of Pune. He is none other than Director of College of Engineering Pune, Dr. B. B. Ahuja sir. Sir has around 130 research papers and 14 patents to his credit and has guided over 21.
Thank you.
Please put your hands together for them.
A little introduction that I am a teacher is more than enough, so thank you. Good evening, friends, dignitaries on the dais, Professor Kakre, Professor Padole, Professor Abhyankar, all from the education field, also the principals of the Raisoni group of institutions, Dr. Karatkar, Dr. Paliwal, Dr. Ms. P.P. Bajaj. From the industry we have Mr. Hari Ishwaran, and the organizers of this today's meet, Shri Shreyas Ji and Shri Ajit Tatya Ji, both from the Raisoni group. I would like to thank them for giving me an opportunity to meet all of you and talk to you for some time. गेल्या वर्षी माझ्या मित्राच्या मुलाला CAP मध्ये ऍडमिशन मिळाल्यानंतर तो त्याला ॲडमिशन कॅप राऊंड थ्रू मिळाली. मी काय डायरेक्ट ॲडमिशन घेऊ शकत नाही, इट इज थ्रू दी प्रोसेस. मित्र जरी असलं तरी ही हॅज टू गो थ्रू द प्रोसेस. तर त्याच्या मुलाला माझ्याकडे घेऊन आला आणि माझ्या मित्राच्या चेहऱ्यावर एक वेगळाच उल्हास, एक वेगळाच आनंद होता. आणि त्यांनी तसं गप्पा गोष्टी सुरू झाल्या आणि मी असं बोलता बोलता त्याच्या मुलाला विचारलं, त्याचं नाव राहुल. मी म्हटलं, राहुल, वाय डीड यू चूज कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग? वाय डीड यू चूज कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग? त्या मुलांनी मान खाली केली. मला वाटलं तो लाजतोय का त्याला बोलायचं नाही आहे. 12th चांगले गुण मिळवले आणि मग CAP मध्ये ॲडमिशन मिळाल्यानंतर कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये तो उत्तरच द्यायला तयार नाही. मग मी म्हटलं, भावांना घाबरतो का तू? तुझे भावा माझे मित्र आहेत, काहीच बोलणार नाही, पण तू सांग मला, तू कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये का ॲडमिशन घेतली? तुझी काही विशेष आवड होती का? तुला काय करायचं आहे आयुष्यात? आणि तो हळूच बोलला, एकदम हळू. त्याची मान खालीच होती. तो बोलला, मी ॲडमिशन कॉम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये घेतली का माझे बाबांनी सांगितलं. मुलांना माहीत नसतं की व्हॉट इज टू बी डन विथ इंजिनिअरिंग, वेदर टू टेक कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग, वेदर टू टेक मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वेदर टू टेक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वेदर टू टेक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजिनिअरिंग, कुठल्या शाखेत प्रवेश घ्यायचं फारशी काही कल्पना नसते. मी त्याला परत विचारलं, अजून तुला कोणी इन्फ्लुएन्स केलं कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग? तर म्हणे एक तर बाबांनी सांगितलं म्हणून मी कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग घेतलं, आणि दुसरं म्हणजे मी ज्या क्लासला जात होतो तिथं माझे मित्र कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंगला जाणार आहेत, सगळ्यांनी असं ठरवलं म्हणून मी पण असंच ठरवलं की मी पण कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग. सो दिस इज हाऊ इट इज, दिस इज फॉर द पेरेंट्स. पालकांना एखाद्या वेळेस हे माहीत नसेल की क्लासेसमध्ये जाताना विद्यार्थी काय काय ठरवतात, पण प्रत्येकाची एक काहीतरी एक इमेज, एक कल्पना तयार होते की मी असं करणार, मी असं कसं करणार. व्हॉट इज इंजिनिअरिंग ऑल अबाउट काकरे सरांनी आत्ताच सांगितलं. देर आर थ्री फंक्शन्स ऑफ अन इंजिनियर. फर्स्ट, अन इंजिनियर हॅज टू ॲनलाइज व्हॉट काइंड ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी टू बी यूज फॉर अ गिवन प्रॉब्लम. The second, he has to come out with a prototype of that problem by way of a solution. And the third, most important, how that prototype could be replicated for mass production. I'm sure many of you sitting here will have this question, ki what branch of engineering to choose? Which college to choose? Barabar hai na? Yes or no? COEP, College of Engineering, Pune. It is an 165-year-old college, started in 1854, the third oldest college in Asia. In 2003, we became autonomous. कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग पुण्याला स्वायत्तता मिळाली महाराष्ट्र सरकारकडून 2003 साली, द फर्स्ट कॉलेज इन द स्टेट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. आणि आम्ही काय केलं स्वायत्तता मिळवून? द कॉलेज वॉज एक्झिस्टिंग अर्लियर ऑल्सो. आपल्याला असं कधी प्रश्न पडलं का की आय आय टीच्या मुलाला नोकरी मिळते का नाही, किंवा एन आय टीमध्ये शिकणाऱ्या विद्यार्थ्याला नोकरीचा प्रॉब्लेम आहे का नाही, किंवा मिळणार का नाही, असं काही आहे का? आपण ग्राह्य धरतो की आय आय टीमध्ये मिळालं, एन आय टीमध्ये ॲडमिशन मिळाली, ट्रिपल आय टीमध्ये ॲडमिशन मिळाली की नक्की नोकरी भेटणार. व्हाय डू यू कम टू इंजिनिअरिंग? आज आपण इंजिनिअरिंगकडे का वळतो? Because engineering at every stage gives us challenges. It tells us how we can better life. So these institutes are autonomous. IITs, triple IITs, NITs and ICERs and so many other institutes. And what is the best thing about this autonomy in all these institutes, including COEP, including Raisoni, there are so many other colleges also in Pune who are autonomous. The best thing about an autonomous institute is that they can design their own curriculum, they can design their own syllabus at the pace at which industry needs the changes in the curriculum. They can make the curriculum very, very adaptive to what is expected by the industry. Today, if you look at, you know, Kakle Sarani Sangitla, Industry 4.0, we are at the cusp of the fourth industrial revolution, Industry 4.0. Industry 5.0 is also not very far away. And what is it that we are looking at? If you look at the half-life of engineering, students will understand what half-life is all about. If you look at the half-life of engineering, it's 2 to 3 years today. That means by the time our students, these students sitting here, when they take admission into engineering, by the time they come out of college, they finish their graduation in 4 years, they would be just about capable enough to get their first job. After that, second job onwards, they will have to struggle in life. Because the way technology is changing, to keep pace with that, you need to keep learning lifelong. Engineering is all about application of maths and sciences. All young students sitting here, if your maths and science is very good, you will never face difficulty in getting a job. And today, if I ask, why do you want a job? Why do you look for a job? Why can't we engineers think of becoming entrepreneurs and giving jobs to each one or to many? Instead of looking for a job, I can become a job provider. Rather than seeking a job, I provide jobs. And that is possible in 4 years, provided the curriculum that we go through is adaptive. This you can get in any autonomous institute. So you should look for institutes where curriculum is adaptive, where you can have a bright future ahead. You can take any branch of engineering. Today, the way technology is emerging, computers has become common to each and every walk of life. We already talk of digital India and soon a digital country. It's just a few years from now. So computers is something which everyone should be knowing. And technology is becoming more and more integrated. 10 years ago, we didn't know that there are going to be cars which will be microprocessor controlled. Today we talk of cars. Our country has a mandate. By 2030, there would be electric vehicles on the road in our country, which means all vehicles will be battery operated. What happens to the 59,000 petrol pumps, petrol stations, diesel stations we have in the country? They will all be converted into charging sources for charging batteries through a smart grid. So does it mean that I must go in for electrical engineering today? If you look at electronics, although we are, you know, we take pride and we want to make everything in India, we say made in India, but if you look at electronic products, although they are labeled made in India, at the component level, they are not made in India. The components are imported, components are made in Southeast Asia, they are brought to India, assembled in India. Why? Because if you bring a product from abroad, there is more customs duty. So they are brought at the component level, assembled in India, and then sourced out. But soon we will be having our own manufacturing units of manufacturing at the nanoscale. So should we look at electronics? Kakde sir talked of smart homes, smart buildings, smart cities. What colleges need today? Smart kids. Are you smart? If you are smart, then you should do engineering. Why? Because every industry is looking for a student who can think, who can create, who can ideate. Creativity, innovation is the buzzword.
each student sitting here, you can take any course of engineering, any course that you like, but you should be passionate about it. If you are a passionate engineer, you will get a job or you will be able to create jobs. But if you are not passionate, even if you come to CAP, you will not get a job. You have to be passionate about what you are doing. And you have this opportunity of looking at colleges, autonomous colleges, where the curriculum keeps revising. Our college chairman, first chairman, now we have another chairman, first chairman at, because this autonomous colleges, you know, for us, COEP, the board of governors was decided by the government of Maharashtra, and Dr. F.C. Kohli, I do not know if you've heard of him, Dr. F.C. Kohli, he is the founder of TCS. He is regarded as father of IT in India. And he is now 94 years old. And when we became autonomous, he was the first chairman board of governors of College of Engineering, Pune. Now we have Dr. Vijay Bhatkar, who's father of supercomputing. All of you know the Param series of computers invented by him. He is our chairman board of governors. So one day I was sitting with Dr. F.C. Kohli and I asked him this question: how can we bring about academic excellence at COEP? And he said there are three things that can bring about academic excellence. I said, sir, what are those three things? He said the first is curriculum. Give the best curriculum, the current curriculum, to your students. I said, what is the second? He said, the faculty. And I said, what is the third? He said, the students themselves. He said, if you have this right mix, you will be able to produce the best of engineers. But what he underlined was the curriculum. We look at technology evolving. नाही कसं असतं टीचरला एकदा माईक पोडियम ऑडियन्स दिलं तर इंटरनल क्लॉक इज सेट टू 60 मिनिट्स पण मला 5 मिनिटाची संधी होती पण आय विल टेक 2-3 मोर मिनिट्स सो वी टॉक ऑफ LEDs टुडे पॉवर सेविंग डिव्हायसेस नाउ दिस LEDs दॅट वी मेक टुडे फॉर our consumption, mankind consumption, humans use LEDs in different places. We talk of the correlated color temperature of the LEDs and we define it in terms of lux or lumens or whatever it is. But if that same LED is to be used in horticulture for growing plants, then I must know the photosynthetic photon flux density. That means I must know what is the impinging density of the photons that should fall on the plant so that they can grow in an LED atmosphere. Which means I must know plants. The point that I'm trying to make is that at COEP and probably in other autonomous colleges also, probably even at Sony, we have introduced biology in our curriculum. Now all of you students sitting here have taken maths and you wanted to say we don't like biology, but if you get into engineering today, you have to learn. Professor Kakde said you have to learn biology, you have to learn life sciences. Because everything is getting integrated. The way technology is evolving. That means an engineer today, what the companies need today is jack of all. You should know everything. So every engineer aspirant sitting here today must know basics of electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, electronics engineering, computer, IT, instrumentation, sensors, automation. Sensors play a very important role in our life today. Kakle sir mentioned artificial intelligence, machine learning. We are developing machines which can think like humans, which can mimic humans. Imagine 10 years from now, cars will talk to one another. I mean, we see it a dream today in India, but in the West, it's already there. We have autonomous cars, driverless cars. So what happens when we have driverless cars coming to our country 10 years down the line? Those parents sitting here, their grandchildren, the parents, this is for the parents, your grandchildren will not need licenses when they become 18. Because they will be autonomous cars, so there is a question of a license, a driving license. Cars won't have drivers. So the way technology is evolving, we need to keep pace with it, which means we have to keep learning lifelong. When I graduated, probably one had to relearn 3 to 4 times in his career because one had 3 to 4 job changes. Students sitting here will have at least 10 job changes in their life career, which means you have to keep learning all your life. Why? Because technology is getting obsolete and you need to specialize. We are becoming global and we are in a future which is unpredictable. We are going to prepare engineers for tomorrow and the tomorrow is not known today. But the best that we can do is give you the current technology, and for that, certainly an autonomous institute could be a good choice. But whatever branch you choose, I'm telling you, each branch is equally important, and down the line, all these branches are going to merge. Probably, according to me, there is, from 10 years from now, there's not going to be anything like a mechanical engineer, a civil engineer, a chemical engineer, an electronics engineer, an electrical engineer. There is only going to be one engineer, and that is solutions engineer. Are you able to give solutions to the industry? If you are able to give solutions, you continue in the profession. So you want a job? What kind of engineering you would select? Anything that you are passionate about. Every engineering is going to be important. Everything is going to be integrated. So if you remain passionate and if you are open to anything and everything that is happening around you, you will survive the competition. There are so many mothers sitting here. We'll give the same recipe to every mother sitting here to make a curry. The ingredients will be the same. The recipe is the same. But if you taste the curry of every mother, it will taste different. Why? Because they have made it differently. So what will survive is innovation. What will survive is passion. So I wish you all the very best. Whatever job careers that you choose, whatever job profiles that you want to have in future, but be passionate. If you are passionate, you will get everything in life. That passion of learning, passion of doing something different. Right? With this, I leave you and wish you all the very, very best. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Now, our next panelist is Dr. Pramod Padoe. He is director of VNIT Nagpur. Mechanisms and machine design, finite element methods, and biomechanical engineering
are his research areas. He has guided 17 PhD research scholars and supervised more than 50 M.Tech dissertations. He has more than 140 research publications and 2 patents to his credit, and has authored several books. Professor Padole has visited various countries like Germany, UK, USA, Romania, France, and Hong Kong for presenting his research work, and has chaired technical sessions at prestigious international conferences. Professor Padole has also worked as president of Biomedical Engineering Forum and developed functional and applied technologies and implants. He has successfully completed more than 14 consultancy projects in the area of appropriate technology, design and finite element analysis, which were funded by Department of Science and Technology, Ministry of Human Resources and Development, KVIC and AICTE New Delhi. I request Dr. Pramod Padole sir to share his valuable thoughts about the creativity and innovation with the August gathering. Sir, please.
Thank you. Very good evening to all of you. Dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, my student friends and parents. At the outset, I thank the organizer for inviting me here for this program to interact with you. I also appreciate and the efforts taken by this organizer to bring you all here, because I think this is very necessary in this today's world of competition. The parents and the students, they are having a lot of queries, apprehensions and questions about what are the opportunities available, what is the scope, what will be the openings as against their aspirations. And I suppose that this kind of forum will definitely help them to answer some of their questions. I remember that in 80s and early 90s, the number of engineering institutions were limited, then the students coming out, they were also limited. The job opportunities were also not to that extent, but the whole system was relatively small. And so the problems were also relatively less. But after the globalization and the open market and those kind of things, the job opportunities have increased. But at the same time, the institutions have also increased a lot. The number of students who are coming out, they are multifold. And then therefore, there are these kind of issues of what kind of branch I should select, which new college I should select, and those are the issues coming up. And this kind of forum will definitely help to resolve these kind of things. One of the days you can say that you should have just a sort of a good subject knowledge and you get the job. Yes, I would say that the basic engineering knowledge required is very, very, very essential. There is no doubt, nothing can replace that. But at the same time, you also required other qualities and the skills, like the soft skills are required, the communication skill is required, you have to work in a team, you have to lead the team, they require some sort of a professional experience, the exposure to the industries, the professional ethics, all those things are nowadays required to have a good sort of opportunities in the industries. And I have seen that many of the institutions, particularly which are autonomous, they are right from the first year, they are trying to see that they are imparting this kind of knowledge to the students, so that when he or she comes out of the institutions, they are having these soft skills and other skills also, which are very much required for the job and other kind of things. Then as rightly said by Professor Ahuja and Professor Kakade, an industry required a jack of all sort of a person. Industry required a multifaceted personality. They want that he or she should have a knowledge of multiple areas. And for that, the interdisciplinary kind of approach or multidisciplinary approach, that is very much required. I've been just told about me that I am working in biomedical engineering. In fact, I am mechanical engineer, but from last almost 13 years, I am working in biomedical engineering, and I have added more than 5 students in this area. And this has happened again incidentally, not by choice or not by this thing, but now the institutions are coming up with a sort of a curriculum where this multidisciplinary approaches are there. There are the options like major and the minor, which many of the institutions, particularly autonomous institutions, they are having this kind of thing. The major means, suppose I am mechanical engineer, then I will be having my major subjects in mechanical engineering, but I can select some of the minor subjects from either for computer science or for electronics. So when I am coming out of this thing, I will be having good knowledge of mechanical engineering and also the electronics or computer science, and therefore naturally my employability is going to improve. So these are some of the things. Then, as rightly said by Professor Kakde, many of the institutions, they are also providing the exposure to the students for the industry. They are giving them a 3 months or 6 month industry internship, which definitely help the students for in his career. So these things are required, which are out of box. The regular kind of engineering teaching and learning may not help. Of course, that is required, but these other things are also very much required. I was just talking about this biomedical engineering. In VNIT, we are having a complete BETIC projects. Professor Ahuja is also part of that. And then we are having biomedical engineering center and also biomedical engineering forum. Incidentally, I am the president of that biomedical engineering forum. And you'll be surprised to know that there are about more than 50 to 60 doctors by professions who are the part of that forum, and of course the engineers are also there. And we are trying to attend many of the problems which are related to biomedical engineering. For example, we have developed a software of image processing. Again, the electronics has come into picture. The CT images are there. If you see the CT scan report, that is in 2D form, and many of us, we could not understand the things, but the whole data is there. So what we did, we got that data, we stacked it properly, and then we converted that 2D CT scan into a 3D model. About those kind of nowadays softwares are available like Unix, but then we develop on our own a software even which is better than the Unix. So it is required, very much required, that it is not only one branch or knowledge of one branch which is required, but you require the knowledge of various branches together. We are trying to find out what will be the effect of the, if the blood is flowing through the renal artery and there is a blockage, then how that is going to affect the secondary hypertension, how that is going to affect the blood flow to the kidney, how it will be reduced. So again, these are the impact problems faced by the doctors, but the engineers can definitely help them. So there is a lot of changes are happening in the engineering. It is not like a conventional engineering. So you have to think out of box. You have to think disruptive type of thinking. Then only you survive in this competitive worlds. And it is not only that you have to just think of your technical knowledge and this thing, which is definitely required, but as rightly said by somebody, it is not that we are just going to seek the job. Now, gone are the days that you can also be a job provider. And in many of the institutions, like in VNIT, we are having the entrepreneurship development courses right from the second year. And those are being run by our alumni association. I suppose in many of the other institutions also, they are going right from the first semester or second semester for the concept of the entrepreneurship development and the various issues related to that. They are teaching them. So they are trying to not only make the engineers just getting a job, but you can also become a job provider. And there are many, in fact, the sort of schemes from the government of India and other Maharashtra government, like for what is pre-incubation, then incubation, startups, Make in India. There are many startup schemes are there, wherein if you do these things systematically, then after coming out from your fourth year or these things, you can become an entrepreneur also. But for that, you required this kind of a solid training, which can be given by the institutions, and definitely many of the autonomous institutions, they are going ahead with this kind of the training right from the inception of that students in the institution. And for that, they are giving a training of how you should think innovatively, out-of-box thinking, what is IPR, and how to get the patent. So this sort of support the institutions are giving. And as rightly said, that is not just knowledge, but you must have passion, you must have innovative thinking, then only you can face the challenges. The innovative thinking or out-of-box thinking is very, very, very essential if you want to become a good engineer and if you want to get a job, but also to provide a job. A small example that I will give you, that how the out-of-box thinking or innovative thinking is there. There was a sort of a competition of a drawing, painting. And the subject was, they have to paint the Ravana and some scene about the Ravana. And all the students, they painted Ravana with 10 faces. And all of them, they draw those faces in a horizontal direction. Right? And there was only one student who draw 10 faces in a vertical direction. So naturally, when the examiners, they saw those paintings, they were surprised to see this one painting, and that how come that student have drawn 10 faces but in vertical direction. So they just called that student and they asked, how come that this idea came to you? He said, sir, there is nothing written. It is written that he has got 10 faces. It is not that whether it is in horizontal plane or in vertical direction. So I thought that I should draw it in a vertical direction. So they asked me, why? What is the logic behind that? He said, sir, that in horizontal direction we can expand, but in vertical direction we can grow. So that is the idea behind him. And then he said that the face which is at the top, he can see the from a longer distance. So he can have a better vision than if I am having in the horizontal direction. So these are the things that you have to think out of box, and you have to have innovative, you must have passion for learning. Then only, as Professor Ahuja said, that there is nothing like this branch or that branch. All the branches are equally good and they are going to merge in one. They are all interdisciplinary things. Now we are having a course which is advanced materials and the manufacturing, where there is a materials and the manufacturing are mechanical. They are clubbed together. So these things are going to happen. In many of the IITs, you see that if you are not getting, suppose, admissions in a branch in which you desire, you can, suppose you are getting admissions in metallurgy and you want in mechanical, then they are having a sort of a system that for 3 years you can do the major subjects of metallurgy, and then in the next 2 years you can get the subjects, or you can select the open electives of the mechanical engineering and you can get the degree of metallurgy and mechanical. So there are many such innovative things are going to happen. So you should not worry about what kind of branch or what kind of this thing is there. Every branches are equal. Only thing is that you have to select the institutions which are having good faculty. Then, as rightly said, that if they are autonomous, then definitely it helps them because they have got better flexibility. They can change their syllabus, they can change their curriculum, which will suit to the industries. They can build all this kind. They can have better interaction with the industry. Those things are possible if there is a autonomy. So I am appealing to all the parents and the students that while selecting your institutions or branch or these things, you must keep all these things in your mind. That first of all, the institution should be good, then their faculty should be good, and if they are having sort of autonomy for meeting with the challenges of the industry, that will definitely going to help, and that will definitely going to good and the current knowledge to your son or daughter, so that it becomes easy for him to either get a job or to start his own business or entrepreneurship. So I am again thankful to the organizers for inviting me here and having a sort of interaction with you. I wish all these students the best of luck for their career. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Before moving ahead, dear friends, every now and then we talk about industry-academia interaction. So far, from the dais we learned or we heard from academicians who definitely have worked with the industries, but they were hardcore academicians from the academia institutes. Let us put hand together for our next panelist, who is from industry, Mr. Hari Ishwaran Iyer. He is head contracts and procurement division of Larsen & Toubro. He is working in the area of construction management, supply chain management, talent management, analytics and digitization over the last 35 years. He is expert into project handling, team leadership and finance, and has high level of interpersonal skills. I request him to put forward his thought about industry application oriented engineering education curriculum. Sir, please.
Thank you, sir. COEP ke director sahab ne bola ki I am wired for 60 minutes. Bola ki I am, agar teacher ho, to sirf teacher bolna, baki kuch bolne ka nahi. I am indeed grateful to Shreyas and Reed sahab for having brought the industry perspective. Main jo hai Pune ka hi rehne wala hu, and I have been educated in Pune only. Or as I am in Larsen & Toubro, which is India's largest company, top in the Forbes list. The Forbes list hoti hai, jo America ki worldwide list hoti hai, usme Larsen & Toubro is number one in India as the best place to work in. And isse pehle jab inhone pucha ki students kya karna chahte hain, तालियां अभी बजी हैं, लेकिन उससे पहले मुझे लगा कि एकदम स्टूडेंट्स की हलचल है कि क्या करना चाहते हैं हम. अजय जी यहां पे हैं. आई ब्रॉट वन पीपीटी, इज इट देयर? ओके, थैंक यू. तो मैं देख रहा हूं कि यहां पे देयर लॉट ऑफ पेरेंट्स, लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. इन माय टाइम और आवर टाइम इंडस एकेडमिशिया ने जो भी बोलना है बोल दिया है. नाउ वी हैव ऑल्सो गॉन थ्रू सम टाइम. ये स्टूडेंट्स जो अपने टाइम से गुजर रहे हैं, हर इरा का जो है अलग चैलेंज होता है. आई विल स्टार्ट विद माय ओन सन. अभी वो जो है, माय वाइफ इज अ गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट और मैं ठहरा इंजीनियर. 5-6 साल पहले हमारी हुई थी 10th 11th 12th स्टैंडर्ड में कि कर बनेगा क्या. वाइफ ने बोला पूरी लाइफ लगा दी कि डॉक्टर बनेगा ही. जब डिसीजन आया कि बायोलॉजी लेना है कि इंजीनियरिंग लेना है, उस रात, पिछली रात को हमारी बहुत बहस हुई थी घर में, मतलब 1 बजे तक. मैंने पूरी जोर लगा कि इंजीनियरिंग, क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स, पार्टिकल थियरी, एआई, रोबोटिक, ये वो पूरी लगी रही कि ऑपरेशन, सर्जिकल सर्जन बनना है, कि देखो बेटा इसी में है लाइफ, है क्या है, मतलब मौत और मतलब जिंदगी और मौत के लिए आप डिसाइड करोगे. 1:30 बजे उन्होंने डिसाइड किया कि आई विल गो फॉर मैथ्स, नॉट बायोलॉजी. आई वॉज सो हैप्पी, सुकून, मतलब अपने डैडी को हर समय मैं जो प्रार्थना करता हूँ, तो आई वॉज वेरी वेरी हैप्पी. और वाइफ एकदम चुपचाप, उस दिन रात को कोई बात नहीं हुई, डे वॉज ओवर. आफ्टर 3-4 डेज जब बैलेंस आया इसमें, तो मैंने उससे पूछा कि हाउ इज इट यार, कि मैंने इम्प्रेस कर दिया तुमको, पुरुषोत्तम उनका नाम है मेरे बेटे का. तो बोला ऐसे कोई इम्प्रेस वगैरह की बात नहीं है, ऐसी एक लड़की है मेरे क्लास में जो बायोलॉजी लेना चाहती है, लेकिन बहुत अकड़ती है वो. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू बी विथ हर. लाउडर. तो फाइनली इट इज जस्ट अपने गट से चलिए. हम पुणे से हैं, रायसोनी का आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस इज वन ऑफ द, लाइक इफ यू लुक एट सुंदर पचाई और सत्य नडेला, यू आर हैंडलिंग गूगल एंड माइक्रोसॉफ्ट टुडे, देयर स्कूल्स और कॉलेजेस आर नोन बाय देम. सो इट इज वन अमंगस्ट यू or two amongst you, all of you, who have to set the path for what you are. Hamare time mein agar aapne science nahi liya hai, to aap nalayak ho. Ye sab hans rahe hain, hum usi era se aate hain. I am 60 years old now. Theek hai, अगर आपने उसके बाद कॉमर्स नहीं मिला तो मतलब ओके नालायक नहीं हो, चल जाए, चल जाएगा सोसाइटी में, और आर्ट्स मिला तो मतलब सब समझो कि जस्ट यू आर द लास्ट, गए गुजरे हो तुम, मतलब कोई देखता ही नहीं अपनी तरफ, मैरिज मार्केट की बात ही छोड़ दो। आज वो है नहीं, आज बिल्कुल है नहीं। मेरा बेटा कंप्यूटर साइंस इंजीनियरिंग कर रहा है, ही इज टॉकिंग ऑफ जॉइनिंग स्टार्टअप, मतलब आज वर्ल्ड इज फ्लैट, आपके हाथ पे मोबाइल पे सब कुछ है, यू कैन कनेक्ट विथ इन्वेस्टर्स इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स इफ यू हैव अ आइडिया। वी वर टॉकिंग टू गूगल द अदर डे, दे वर सेइंग कि आपके पास एक थॉट हो तो आपको हम पैसे देंगे। थॉट कैसे आते हैं, बोलो किसी ने ऐसा स्ट्रेंज थिंकिंग किया कि जो मैं खाना तीन टाइम क्यों खाना चाहिए दिन में, आई शुड हैव ओनली ब्रेकफास्ट लंच और डिनर के लिए वन कैप्सूल इन मॉर्निंग और अपने आप अपनी न्यूट्रिएंट्स निकलनी चाहिए। ट्रस्ट मी टुडे दैट मेडिसिन इज अवेलेबल। तो क्या है, हम टीयर टू टीयर थ्री सिटीज, आई एम फ्रॉम पुणे, फ्रॉम सेंट जोसेफ, आई ग्रेजुएटेड फ्रॉम हियर, आई वॉज इन द आर्मी फॉर 26 ईयर्स, नाउ आई एम इन द इंडस्ट्री विद द टॉप कंपनीज फॉर लास्ट 7-8-9 ईयर्स। एक डर इस ऑडियंस से निकालना चाहता हूँ, मतलब पुणे में पूरी लाइफ गुजारी है मैंने, कि टीयर टू टीयर थ्री पुणे जीनियसेस यहीं से बनती हैं। लेट मी टेल यू, जितनी डेडिकेशन पैशन की बात की लोगों ने, जीनियस टीयर टू टीयर थ्री सिटीज से ही बनते हैं। वी हैव लार्ज कंपनीज हैव डिसाइडेड कि एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी जो बच्चे हैं ना, वो एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी थिंग्स नहीं कर सकते। आप ऑर्डिनरी बच्चों को पैशन दीजिए, वो एब्सोल्युटली एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी थिंग करके दिखाएंगे। और हमने रायसोनी यूनिवर्सिटी से कुछ बच्चे आए थे हमारे पास, ऐसा है कि आउट ऑफ टर्न आए थे, अगर हमारी रेगुलर प्रोसेस से जाते हैं तो हम उनको स्टाइपेंड भी देते हैं इंजीनियरिंग के समय, लेकिन कुछ ऐसे नहीं सर, हम एलएनटी का नाम चाहिए हमको बस, तो स्टाइपेंड नहीं चाहिए आपका, अगर फूड कूपन मिल जाएगा बहुत है। ऐसे आए थे हमारे पास 8-10 बच्चे, एंड आई एम हैप्पी एंड वेरी प्राउड टू टेल यू दैट 2 or 3 ऑफ देम आर बेटर देन द पीपल वी हैव गॉट इन द कंपनी इट्सेल्फ, बट इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ पैशन। मतलब आप सब में ऐसा एक चिंगारी होना चाहिए, और पेरेंट्स को मैं खास करके बोलता हूँ कि आप जो है बच्चों को अपना छोड़ दीजिए, बिकॉज आई वॉज टेलिंग लास्ट टाइम, आई थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ इट मिस्टर अजीत रायसोनी एंड श्रेयस हैव डिसाइडेड कि मैं यहाँ पे आपसे बात करूँ। मैंने कहा हमारा एक ही लास्ट जनरेशन है कि हम अपने डैडी मम्मी से भी डरते थे और बच्चों से भी डरते हैं, हमारे बच्चे उस जनरेशन में नहीं बनेंगे, ये बिल्कुल जो करना चाहते हैं वो करेंगे, और बहुत बहुत है, मतलब एरिया पूरा खुला हुआ है, मैदान खुला हुआ है, अगर पसंद नहीं आए तो सुनो मत, दिस शुड बी द एटीट्यूड, देयर इज इनफ स्पेस। रायसोनी हैज गॉट वन वेरी ग्रेट फीचर विच वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन द इंडस्ट्री, वो क्या है कि जो इंजीनियर्स बन के आते हैं तो हमारे फोरमैन जो होते हैं 8-10 साल से फोरमैन का ही काम कर रहा है, वो देखता है कि साहब ये तो इंजीनियर है, इसने पूरा थियोरी किया हुआ है, इसको साइट के बारे में कुछ पता ही नहीं है, क्या करना है क्या नहीं करना है, और सैलरी मेरे से 5 गुना ले रहा है। हमारी प्रॉब्लम यहाँ थी, 2-3 साल तक हम सोच रहे थे कि इंजीनियर तो टेक ओवर कर देगा उसको, 5-6 साल में वो टेक ओवर कर देगा, लेकिन वो काम नहीं जानता जो फोरमैन जानता है। दैट वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट थिंग दे हैव डन बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ ऑटोनॉमी और व्हाट डायरेक्टर सीओईपी सेड इज दैट ऑटोनॉमस इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस हैव दे कैन डिसाइड देयर सिलेबस and therefore they have got this 6 months compulsory internship with industries which we are also ready to look at to take them at no cost. This is the greatest thing. Now this Raisoni has done and Shreyas has done, but any one of you who join it, you also have a hand in that. Aap blame nahi kar sakte ho ki Raisoni ke paas autonomy hai lekin wo jo marzi karenge karenge, aapki bhi jaan pehchan jo hai hum logon se bahut zyada hai. So my request to all of you is that you must participate as a partner when you join such colleges and make sure that they give the best to you. In this audience, there are people who know much, much more than all of us put together here. That is my conviction. At one point of time, I was also sitting there. And this is my conviction to make sure that you are a partner to everything that is happening. Passion should be there and you must realize that you are good. Ajay sir, can we see the video? If it is there, or I'll just take 2 minutes to show you this video. Is there sound?
Are Dhoni? Idhar kyun baitha hai?
Good evening, sir.
Evening.
Bas aise, sir.
Bad. Bad.
सर वो हमारा रूममेट लोग का ड्यूटी था तो क्वार्टर में बैठे यहाँ बैठे बात तो एक ही है सर
और बैठे बैठे क्या सोच रहा था
कुछ नहीं सर बस ऐसे ही सर कुछ नहीं
अरे बात करना चाहिए मन हल्का हो जाता है
सर हम सोच रहे थे कि हम कर क्या रहे हम एक क्रिकेटर है लेकिन टीसी का काम कर रहे हैं यहाँ खड़गपुर स्टेशन पे ये बात नहीं है हमको ये काम छोटा लगता है सर लेकिन हमको ये समझ में नहीं आ रहा कि हम यहाँ से आगे कैसे खेलेंगे रोज हमारी लाइफ में क्या चल रहा है सर हम ही जानते हैं 8013 अप और 8029 डाउन के बीच में हमारा जॉगिंग हो जाता है क्रिकेट में हम टीम के सामने खड़े होकर फाइनल इकट्ठा करते हैं ना तो हमारा गेम इंप्रूव हो रहा है सर ना हमको कोई आगे अपॉर्चुनिटी मिल रहा है बस रणजी खेले जा रहे हैं कब तक और कैसे चलेगा सर कभी कभी तो मन करता है कि सब कुछ छोड़ छाड़ के वापस चले जाए लेकिन फिर पापा का चेहरा सामने आ जाता है रोज रात को जब क्वार्टर लौटता है ना सर तो ऐसा लगता है आउट होकर पवेलियन लौट रहे पूछ रहे थे ना कि यहां पे क्यों बैठा है यह सोचते रहते हैं बस कहीं पे भी बैठे
अपने बाप इतना सब कुछ सोच रहा था
सॉरी सर पर आई एम स्टार्ट फीलिंग डिप्रेस सर
अच्छा तुम हमको एक बात बताओ जब तुमको फुल टॉस मिलता है तो तुम क्या करता है
सर
जब तुमको फुल टॉस मिलता है तो तुम क्या करता है
हिट मारता हूं
जूसी हाफ वाले मिलता है तो
ड्राइव करता हूं
अच्छा आउटस्विंगर हो तो
छोड़ देते
अच्छा इनस्विंगर हो तो
डिफेंड करता है
और जब तुमको अनप्लेबल कोई बाउंसर रहता है तो क्या करता है
डक करता है
बस यही तो लाइफ है ऐसा समझो ये सब बाउंसर्स हैं और अभी तुमको डक करना है इसमें ज्यादा सोचने का क्या है लाइफ में सब बॉल एक समान थोड़ी ना मिलेगा मेरिट पे खेलना है और टिके रहना है द स्कोरबोर्ड विल कीप मूविंग
सर
और ये जॉब आपको लेके तुम ज्यादा टेंशन मत लो जब तक हम है तुम्हारा जब मन करे जहां मन करे खेलो अटेंडेंस वेटेंडेंस तुम्हारा जो भी है वो हम देख लेगा डोंट वरी
थैंक यू सर हम वो टेनिस टूर्नामेंट खेलेंगे बाईस साल की जगह 18
स्विच ऑफ दिस बिकॉज अभी अटेंडेंस की बात आई वो ठीक नहीं है अटेंडेंस कोई नहीं देखेगा सब मतलब एब्सेंट मीन्स एब्सेंट बट कहने का मतलब यह है कि दिस वी यूज इन कॉर्पोरेट ऑल्सो हर एक लाइफ के हर जो है मोमेंट आप पकड़ सकते हो अगर आप हम जो भी बोल रहे हैं वो बाउंसर है आपके लिए तो डक कर दीजिए बस दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बट चेस योर पैशन इट हैज इट इन यू श्रेयस हैज इनवाइटेड मी टू पुणे इज माय प्लेस वेयर आई वाज बॉर्न ब्रेड आई हैव बीन एजुकेटेड ही डजंट नो इट बट एंड आई एम टॉकिंग टू दिस ऑडियंस आई एम टेलिंग यू यू विल प्रोड्यूस जीनियस फ्रॉम दिस फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट्स इट इज माई गट फीलिंग दो चार और पॉइंट बुमराह आप बच्चे तो जानते होंगे अगर बुमराह ने कोई कोचिंग अटेंड की होती ना अर्ली लाइफ में तो आज इंडिया का नंबर वन या वर्ल्ड का नंबर वन बॉलर कभी बनता ही नहीं वो ये जो लगान जैसे बॉलिंग करता है वो सो इट सेज कि अगर आपके पास कोई कोच ही शुड नॉट डिस्टर्ब योर द ओरिजिनल वे दैट यू आर बॉर्न बाय द लॉर्ड यू शुड नॉट डिस्टर्ब इसलिए ऐसा नहीं इंजीनियरिंग में छुपने का सबको जरूरी नहीं है फैक्ट इज नो मैटर इन वॉट यू आर गुड यू शुड गो फॉर दैट बट एडवांटेज इंजीनियरिंग में ये है कि अगर रेनबो के 7 कलर हैं तो इंजीनियरिंग में ऑलमोस्ट आपको सारे 7 कलर दिख जाएंगे बाकी क्या है आपको एक आध दो कलर दिख जाएगा क्योंकि हर एक एरिया लाइफ के हर एक अगर आप 3D प्रिंटिंग लीजिए इंजीनियरिंग से स्टार्ट होती है यूथ होती है मेडिकल साइंस में हमने इम्प्लांट लगवाई है तो हमारे सामने वो है 3D प्रिंट करके मॉडल आ गया सामने एकदम सो इंजीनियरिंग इज एब्सोल्युटली फाउंडेशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग एंड इन दैट एरिया ट्रस्ट द पीप दोज इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस विच हैव ऑटोमेशन which have autonomy, which have innovation, and which will look for your voice. The most important thing is your own voice. Ramanujam ka pata nahi aap logon ne life padha hai ki nahi, picture to sabhi ne dekhi hogi. Jaise maine ye picture start kiya, pura audience ka energy alag badal gaya pura. Matlab aur bhi dekhna chahte the, jaise 3R ka picture hi dekh lete. Lekin main dekh raha tha wo, but I stopped it jahan pe bola na ki attendance hum dekh lenge, wahan pe rok diya maine usko. Ramanujam was a clerk in Port Trust. He was a clerk in Port Trust of India. He could not pass 12th standard. But uske local teachers wo bolte the ki iske jo formula ya jo ye bachcha likhta hai baith ke, jo formula likhta hai wo kuch humko ajeeb lagte hain. Matlab aisa lagta hai ki isme solution hai lekin uske steps nahi bol pa raha hai. So Ramanujam writes to somebody in Cambridge. Aap uske life padhiye, writes to somebody in Cambridge saying that main to nalayak hu, मैं तो पोर्ट ट्रस्ट में एक क्लर्क हूं और जो है, लेकिन जो लोकल मैथमेटिक्स के टीचर्स हैं वो कह रहे हैं कि जो मैं फॉर्मूला लिखता हूं उसमें कुछ मजा है, मतलब ऐसा कुछ है, तो अगर आप लोगों को लगता है कि मैं वहां पे आ सकता हूं तो आप मुझे बुलाइए. दैट एफर्ट ही मेड टू राइट द लेटर, कैम्ब्रिज कॉल्ड हिम. अगर आप एफर्ट नहीं करोगे, ही वॉज अ पोर्ट ट्रस्ट में क्लर्क थे वो रामानुजम, कैम्ब्रिज कॉल्ड हिम. आज के डेट में वेदर यूनिवर्स वॉज क्रिएटेड बाई बिग बैंग और वेदर इट हैज बीन इट इज अ ब्लैक होल, इट इज स्टिल बीइंग डिसाइड नॉट अंडरस्टूड. बट वो कहते हैं कि रामानुजम के जो फॉर्मूला हैं वो वर्क ऑफ जीनियस है, वो साइंटिस्ट आज भी यूज कर रहे हैं रामानुजम के वो फॉर्मूले, और उन्होंने स्टेप्स नहीं लिखे थे, एंड सोल्यूशन ही दिया था. तो उनसे पूछा गया कि आपने सोल्यूशन क्यों दिया, कहते जब वक्त आएगा तो लोग उसके स्टेप्स लिखेंगे, मुझे सोल्यूशन नहीं पता. इसलिए आप में ऐसे बच्चे यहाँ पे बहुत हैं, मेरा बेटा भी एक, अगर मैं उससे कुछ बात करता हूँ तो बोलता है यू डोंट नो सो डोंट आस्क मी, ही इज डूइंग पाइथन लैंग्वेज एंड ऑल्सो. मैंने कहा था व्हाट इज पाइथन, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन टू मी, डू यू नो अबाउट इट, आई सेड नो आई डोंट नो, सो देन वी विल डिस्कस समथिंग एल्स. फैक्ट है, दैट इज द वे स्टूडेंट्स आर, पेरेंट्स हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट, यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट, दैट इज द वे स्टूडेंट्स आर. स्टीफन हॉकिंग, he has replaced Newton. We are sitting with illustrious engineers here. Stephen Hawking has replaced Newton. Stephen Hawking, agar aap unki life padhiye, he was given up at 12 years, 13 years, ki this boy is cannot live anymore. Last cheez aapko ek batana chahta hu ki we have the best of the industry. I am from Larsen & Toubro. Larsen & Toubro is the ultimate company in India. Matlab people just want to work there. We have understood that it is only the ordinary who can be the extraordinary. So big hand for all of you, and just have absolutely no doubt in your mind. Look for autonomy, do what you want, and can we just run through my slides if you don't mind? I'm sorry because किसी ने स्लाइड इस्तेमाल नहीं किया, मैं तो पूरा स्लाइड बना रहा हूं. एंड लकीली दे डिसाइडेड टू मेक मी द लास्ट स्पीकर, थिंकिंग मैं बॉम्बे से आ रहा हूं इसलिए एक दो मिनट मिल जाएगा इसको. थ्री मोर, थैंक यू मैडम. सो वन मिनट, कैन वी प्रीवियस स्लाइड प्लीज. ओके, दैट्स द वन आई वॉन्टेड. तो दे वॉज अ सर्वे, रीडर डाइजेस्ट ने एक सर्वे किया था वर्ल्ड वाइड की टॉप प्रोफेशनल्स पे, कि इनमें क्या कॉमन है, क्या अलग करते हैं, क्या सभी 4:30 बजे उठते हैं सवेरे, या सभी 1 बजे तक सोते हैं, 1 बजे तक पढ़ते रहते हैं. तो अब्दुल कलाम जी ने बोला था, अब देखिए इंटरप्रिटेशन कैसे होता है. उन्होंने कहा कि अगर बच्चों के पास ड्रीम नहीं होगा तो दे विल नॉट बी एबल टू अचीव एनीथिंग. तो ड्रीम इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो एक बेटा जो उसको इंटरप्रेट करने का उसका देखिए स्टाइल, तो उसने कहा मम्मी का अगले दिन HSC एग्जाम था, मम्मी जल्दी खाना जल्दी लगाइए. बोला क्यों? बोला जल्दी खा के सोना है तभी तो ड्रीम आएगा. अब्दुल कलाम जी को यह सवाल किया गया, अगले मीटिंग में जब बच्चों से बात करते थे उनसे पूछा गया कि आपकी जो इंटरप्रिटेशन ड्रीम की है, तो एक बच्चे ने यह सवाल किया है, तो व्हाट डू यू फील? ही सेड द ड्रीम आई स्पोक अबाउट इज द वन विच डज नॉट मेक पीपल स्लीप, विच इज व्हाट मोस्ट ऑफ देम सेड इज अबाउट पैशन. If you have passion absolutely do what you want, world is at your feet. When the best were interviewed in worldwide, बोला तीन चार क्वालिटियां बताइए कि जो इनके पास कॉमन है. फर्स्ट क्वालिटी यू बिलीव मी, बोला कि क्वालिटी क्या है वर्ल्ड वाइड, जो टॉप 25 प्रोफेशनल थे, बोला कि फर्स्ट क्वालिटी इज कॉमन सेंस. बोला जितने हम टनल में चले जाते हैं तो अपनी कॉमन सेंस ही निकल जाती है. डैडी मम्मी और बेटे का झगड़ा चल रहा है, बेटी का झगड़ा चल रहा है, कॉमन सेंस नहीं आ रहा बीच में. ही सेज मोर यू गेट इनटू टनल मोर यू लैक कॉमन सेंस. सेकेंड क्वालिटी इज वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू लीव यू विथ. सेकेंड क्वालिटी उन्होंने कहा कि अप टू 18 बुक्स इन अ ईयर, अप टू 18 बुक्स इन अ ईयर, बेसिक 20 पेज का बुक हो, 25 पेज का बुक हो, आउटसाइड देयर करिकुलम. लॉट ऑफ पीपल सेड यू कैन नॉट मेक मनी अनलेस यू नो एवरीथिंग, यू शुड नो लिटिल ऑफ ऑल द साइंसेज. वो कहते हैं कि आप जो मर्जी पढ़ो, न्यूज पेपर पढ़ो, आदत पढ़ने की आ जाएगी. तो जैसे 18 बुक्स के करीब, 20 पेज के हो, 25 पेज को, एक साल में जरूर इंसान ने पढ़नी चाहिए. वो बेशक स्टारडस्ट हो, फिल्म फेयर हो, जो भी आप गिनती करते रहिए, बट 18 बुक्स पर ईयर आउटसाइड जो आप कर रहे हो. एंड दिस हैज एक्चुअली ओपनड अप लॉट ऑफ थिंकिंग इन ह्यूमन बींग्स, एंड दैट इज वेयर जीनियसेस हैव बीन क्रिएटेड. आई एम थैंकिंग वंस अगेन श्रेयस एंड अजीत सर टू हैव ब्रॉट मी टू माई place of my learning, Pune. Wish you all the best. God bless you.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful insight. Ladies and gentlemen, hold your breath. We are having a wonderful surprise for you. You will be amazed to see how our young generation is working hand in hand with changing technology. Here is a live example of most talk about man-machine interface.
Kasa gaya Pune? Where's the Josh? So many young students. Come on, kasa gaya Pune? Well, good evening to one and all present here. I am Siddhinath. I've completed second year of my engineering from GHRC. And I'm currently working as an intern in the Center of Excellence in AI and ML. Now, when I was at your place, literally, believe me when I tell you, I was totally freaking out. You guys look pretty calm. But you might be having a few questions, like I did. And to answer those queries, we have with us the best friend that humanity is supposed to be having, that is technology. How many of you are familiar with this device? Come on, raise your hands. How many? So this is Alexa, a smart home device, a smart bot. We have also with us joining one more friend of ours, Career Connect. We will be using Alexa to connect ourselves with her and help her answer our queries. Before we begin, let us see how our friend feels. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
How is the Josh?
Hi, sir. We are good to go.
Well, now that we all are excited, filled with enthusiasm, let us proceed. We all are at a Career Connect event, right? Talking about engineering. Let us see what our creation, which engineers have created, have perspective about us. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
What is your take on engineers?
It is simple. Let me put it this way. Some say that the glass is half full, some say it is half empty. Engineers say it needs to be redesigned.
That's a pretty funny perspective. What do you guys think? Well, before we proceed, I think we missed something. Let our friend have an opportunity to introduce herself. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
Can you please introduce yourself to the audience?
Good evening to one and all present here. I am Career Connect, an artificial intelligence program made by a group of talented engineers from various branches. I am excited to be here with you all at this event.
Well, she is also excited, but there's a myth that I'm hearing. It says that to be a successful engineer, you need to be a genius at mathematics. Can our friend help us with that? Let's see. Alexa, ask Career Connect. Well, she's sometimes a bit shy. Alexa, ask Career Connect. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
I think I'm bad at maths. Should I go for engineering?
Technically, you can always improve your math skills. Also, it may be of comfort to you that an engineer is a person that has forgotten more about math than you ever knew.
Well, now that I've completed 2 years of my engineering, I can tell you all that is somewhat true. Now it's time to step off out of our comfort zone, because it is there where the magic happens, isn't it? By now, engineering seems pretty cool. But I have one more question. Let's see if our friend can help us. Alexa, ask Career Connect. She throws some tantrums like this sometimes.
Alexa, sorry, I do.
Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
Why should I consider engineering as my career option?
Speaking from the point of view of jobs available, with growth rate projected as high as 20% for some branches. In this global era, the world needs in plenty well-equipped, talented graduates with the right attitude. There are also a great opportunities of self-employment. I love engineers. After all, engineers created me and my friends, Cortana and Siri. Oops, did I forget someone?
What do you think? Did you forget someone? Anyone? Well, yeah, she did forget someone. But with that great amount of opportunities and growth rate, I think engineering is literally one of the best career options to go for. There's one more question that keeps popping up in my mind when I see the colleges around India. There's two types of degrees, BE and BTech. What is the difference? Let's ask our guide. Alexa, ask Career Connect. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
What is the difference between BE and BTech?
While BE is data oriented, BTech is skill oriented. BE is more of a study based on theory and BTech is more of application engineering. One will never be able to decide which course is better between the two. Both these courses have their own importance and place in the society.
Well, that is indeed a very useful insight. Now I'll see both of them equally. But sometimes I feel that I'm pretty biased about my branch. Let us see what our friend has to say about it. Alexa, ask Career Connect. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
I think computer science is the best branch. What do you think?
I'm glad that you asked. This is actually not true. It may surprise you to know that mechanical engineers had a major role in my creation, like designing my body. Also, electronics engineers designed my circuits. Industrial engineers made it possible to mass manufacture me. Every branch has a special role. No branch is superior or in any way inferior to one another.
Wow, that's truly a great insight, and I guess now we'll treat each and every branch equally. Well, that has been my time, friends. I hope you enjoyed this session. But before going, I think our friend has something to say. Alexa, ask Career Connect. Alexa, ask Career Connect.
Okay.
It is time to say goodbye.
I started to enjoy being with this lovely people, but I guess a part of the journey is the end. Also, if you want to hang out with me more, then visit the Center of Excellence in AI and ML at GHRCE. We do a lot of cool stuff there. Goodbye everyone. Have a great day. I love you 3000.
That's been it. Thank you everyone.
Alex and Siddhi deserves more clapping. Thank you, Siddhi, and thank you, Alexa.
Yeah, what's your name? Siddhinath. Siddhinath. He is a second year student from GH Raisoni, Pune. Nagpur, okay. You have an offer from COEP.
Yeah.
See, the advantage of being an autonomous institute is that one semester, up to two semesters, you know, we allow students coming at COEP from other autonomous institutes. So if you want to spend a semester or two at COEP, you're welcome.
Yeah.
But when you come to COEP, bring Alexa with you. Yeah. I understand that the transfer rate is 3000, but we will treat you free. So I'm serious. You're welcome. So you can ask your ma'am, can he come to COEP for a semester? You would love to come to COEP. So this is one of the advantage of being in an autonomous institute. As you know, we were told by Professor Kakre, and you will get to know more. One semester you can spend in the industry. You also have an honors and minors, which means that you can take courses from different disciplines. So I'm doing mechanical engineering, and I can take courses from electronics, from computers. Why? Because I didn't get admission there, but I can take additional add-on courses by way of minors, or I can major in my own branch, that is, so honors. So whatever I wish to do, for example, I'll just explain this concept of minors and honors. You want to do that with honors and minors? You want to tell them what it is all about? Okay. Yeah. No, he's feeling shy. Yeah. You should look beyond Alexa also.
So, sir, thank you so much. Please explain the meaning of, you know, honors and minor as well. It's your turn. But thank you so much for offering Siddhi. And almost 50 students have been spent one semester in COEP and VJTI as well. That's the advantage of being in autonomous.
So it's not only being at COEP, probably you can spend one semester abroad in one of the universities.
Yes.
Because it's permissible, it's permitted. So the concept of honors is that I am a student of mechanical engineering. I take additional courses in my own branch, that is in mechanical engineering. And I have honors in automotive technology because I feel that's a growing field that is of interest to me. So it's like I am majoring in automotive technology. I'm a mechanical engineer, so I take additional courses in automotive technology. That is honors. Minors is taking courses from other than my branch. So I'm a mechanical engineer. I take courses in computers, computer programming, and maybe I take 4-5 courses and learn something about computer engineering, which I always wanted to do, but I got admission in mechanical engineering. So this is possible in an autonomous framework. I recall, you know, the days when I started teaching at COEP, and I learned it the hard way. You know, I had to teach AutoCAD, I had to teach AutoLisp in one semester. I didn't know anything about programming. I had to teach basic,
I had to basic language, COBOL, DBASE, none of these exist today. None of these. I mean, it's all obsolete today, you know. And as Mr. Hari Ishwaran mentioned, you know, he talked of Python. My students asked me today, sir, do you know Python? I said, Python is a snake to me. He said, no, Python is a language. You should know Python 3.8, that's the latest. So that is how times have changed. So whatever I learned, whatever I taught, probably does not exist today because it's changing so very rapidly. Probably what remains with me is my C language. Otherwise, everything has changed, you know. I mean, but most important in engineering is, very rightly said by Mr. Hari, is the common sense, the logic. If you have that logic with you, at any point in time in life, you will always succeed. And it's all about being logical. It's all about having common sense. And that's what engineering is all about. So, thank you for this wonderful... He's a second year student, huh? So big round of applause for him.
Thank you, sir. Moving ahead. Next and important one in today's context is our panelist, Dr. Aditya Abhyankar. Dr. Abhyankar is Dean, Faculty of Technology, Savitribai Phule, Pune University, Pune. Born hard academician, he received his MS and PhD degrees from Clarkson University, New York, USA in 2003 and 2006 respectively. He worked as postdoctoral fellow at Clarkson University in 2006-07 and thereafter worked as consultant for Biometrics LLC, West Virginia, USA in 2007. He has also obtained MBA degree with specialization in finance in 2013 and MA degree in Sanskrit with specialization in Vedant in 2012. He is involved in consultancy with number of private industries. His research areas include signal and image processing, pattern recognition, wavelet analysis, biometric system and bioinformatics, machine learning, computer vision, and data analytics. He has in his credit 8 US and 12 Indian patents, and he has received many international and national awards. I request, sir, to kindly address the audience in the purview of upcoming orientations of interdisciplinary engineering education. Sir, please.
So from Alexa back to Aditya. All the respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, all the parents and particularly all the student friends, the young ignited minds in this room. At the outset, I take this opportunity and first of all thank Risonic Group for creating such a wonderful platform. And I would like to pick up from where most of the earlier speakers they left, and that is passion. I know we are really hard-pressed on time, so I'll try and keep it as short as possible. I have a quick five-pointer agenda to share with you so that we can quickly move on to questions and answer session, because I know you'll have lots of questions in your minds. But the first one in this five-pointer agenda is P, that is passion. I completely agree with all the earlier speakers. If you don't have passion about a particular branch, there is absolutely no fun pursuing your education in that particular field. We do such kind of seminars and sessions, and we get to hear all crazy reasons why students they enroll in different branches of engineering. Tu computer engineering la ka gelas baba? Majha ajji chi ichcha hoti. Tu chemical engineering la ka admission ghetlis? Majha building cha satvya majlyavar ek dada rahato. तो म्हणला केमिंज पूर्ण कर मी तुला लगेच यूएसला बोलवून घेतो. सो ऑल क्रेझी रिझन्स अँड स्टुडंट्स दे एंटर इन टू डिफरंट ब्रांचेस ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग विदाऊट रिअलायझिंग वॉट यू आर गोईंग टू डू फॉर नेक्स्ट 4 years. सो आय हॅव अ हंबल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू, प्लीज विजिट दीज गुड इन्स्टिट्यूट्स, COIP, राइसोनी, टॉक टू दी प्रोफेसर्स, विजिट द लॅबोरेटरीज वेअर मॅक्सिमम अमाऊंट इज स्पेंड बाय द इंजिनियर्स अँड गेट टू अंडरस्टँड if you select a particular branch, what exactly are you going to do for next 4 odd years. आपल्या डोक्यात खूप वेगळ्या कल्पना असतात आणि प्रत्यक्षात इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये आपण खूप वेगळं काहीतरी करत असतो. त्याच्यामुळे प्लीज डू व्हिजिट दीज इन्स्टिट्यूशन्स, टॉक टू प्रोफेसर्स, व्हिजिट द लॅबोरेटरीज, गो थ्रू द सिलेबस अँड अंडरस्टँड वॉट इट टेक्स टू बिकम अन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजिनियर फॉर एक्झाम्पल. बट पॅशन इज समथिंग विच इज रिअली गोइंग टू ड्राईव यू अँड दॅट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट फॅक्टर इन माय ओपिनियन एज वेल. द सेकंड फॅक्टर इज डी, दॅट इज डिफरन्शिएटिंग कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. जस्ट इमॅजिन वेन यू विल ग्रॅज्युएट, how many engineers are we going to produce as a country, how many engineering institutions do we have in our country, and in 2023 when you will graduate, how many engineers are we going to produce as a country? And the recruiters, they are not going to take a look at you unless and until you have differentiating characteristics, because there is a rat race out there. Back in 2007, me and a friend of mine, Dr. Deepak, we prepared a parody, and it is even relevant today in 2019. Tumhala ek gammachir parody sangto. 1971 sali ek chitrapat ala hota. Tya chitrapatacha naam hota Bandhan. Ani tya chitrapatat hero hota Jitendra. So for the young generation, Jitendra is father of Tushar Kapoor and Ekta Kapoor. आणि त्या मूवीमध्ये असा एक सीन होता की ज्यामध्ये जितेंद्र घरी धावत धावत येतो आणि त्याच्या आईचं काम दुर्गा खोटेने केलं होतं आणि तो आपल्या आईला सांगतो की मा मैं तो बी ए पास हो गया. अँड द मदर बिकम सो हॅपी दॅट इन्स्टंटली शी कुक्स गज्जर का हलवा. नाऊ इफ दे मेक अ रिमेक ऑफ दिस मूवी इन 2019, अँड दे विल राईट बिकॉज दे हॅव रॅन आउट ऑफ स्टोरीज अँड दे आर रिमेकिंग ऑल द ओल्ड गोल्ड मूवीज. And let's say Ekta Kapoor produces that movie. So the name of the movie will be Kandan because it has to start with K. And let's say Tushar Kapoor plays the role of the hero. And we can assume that the poor chap will get at least a couple of dialogues. Because in most of the movies he is either deaf or dumb. And let's say mother's role is played by whom? Reema Lagu is also no more. Someone. And he comes running back home and says, Ma, main B.Tech pass ho gaya from one of the autonomous institutes. We are talking about smartphones and smart cities, so obviously intelligent mothers. No gajjar ka halwa. The first question will be, placement hua kya? And if the answer is yes, still no gajjar ka halwa. The next question will be, package kitna hai? If the package is good, still no gajjar ka halwa. The next question will be, what are your plans for higher education? Are you going for GRE, GATE, MS in one of the top universities abroad, or M.Tech from one of the IITs, NITs? And this will go on and on and on and on. And that's because, just imagine how many engineers we are going to produce. And unless and until you have a differentiating characteristics, unless and until you show that you are different, the recruiters, they won't be able to notice you. And it is only going back to your DNA, because we all are born different. And then there is a popular saying by Dwayne Penn. He says that I was born intelligent and then I got educated. So that's what our educational system does to us. From 1st standard to 12th standard, you have done what your peers have done. There is not a single opportunity to be formally different, unique, hatke. And that's what now you should strive for in these 4 years of engineering. And it's a journey, it's a process. So if you start it right now, then you will be able to achieve it by the end of your 4th year. The third mantra is F, that is, you should be futuristic. And you should really look out what industry would need 4 years down the line, 3 years down the line, when you will become engineer. And the boundaries between different engineering disciplines, they are getting almost shortened and removed, and now we are in an era of not only interdisciplinary but transdisciplinary research. And what do I mean by being futuristic? I will share with you my story of Google. Google, the kharas futuristic hote. In 2000, I was in the US, I was pursuing my master's from MIT Boston, and in US they pay you only for 9 months. For remaining 3 months you have to earn your own salary. And I was very fortunate that MIT had a tie-up with Google. So I went to Seattle to pursue my internship, and I simply could not understand them. Huge amount of investment, trillions and trillions of dollars, HPC, high computing facility, servers, they were crunching the data in and out from across the globe. Trillions of dollars of investment. And what was the product that came out of Google? Google.com, a platonic, harmless search engine. No irritating pop-up advertisements, nothing. It was not also a news disseminating engine like Hotmail or Rediff. A harmless search engine. So there were only two possibilities. A, these were godmens and they were sent by the Almighty for the upliftment of mankind, which was obviously not the case. So the second obvious option was there was a very futuristic, shrewd business plan that was hidden. And if you really understand what Google has done to us in last 18, 19 odd years, it's phenomenal. In 2000, there was a fear of Y2K. And Google was the first company who announced that we are using grid computing. So your apps will be safe if you are hosting them on our servers. And overnight, Google became a phenomenon. I also like Google example because the company was formed by two PhD scholars from Stanford University. So that reinforces back our faith in educational system. Otherwise, Ishwaran saab ne to education system ka, and we often give examples of school dropouts who made it really big. But Google is also doing huge, big time. And in 2001, I was in US at that time, 9/11 happened. A terrorist attack. This was the same day in 1893 when Swamiji, Swami Vivekananda, uttered those golden words in All Religion Assembly at Chicago, Sisters and Brothers of America. In the same day, 2001, Twin Towers were brought down, terrorist attack, and people were trying to search about it on Google and they could not find anything because Google was not fed live. Immediately in 2002, they introduced Google Live. In 2004, comprehensive search. In 2006, they leveraged upon already existing concept of IoT. 2008, intelligent frameworks. 2010, gridding and intelligent gridding. And 2013, finally they announced that we are in an era of big data analytics. And today, Google literally knows everything about every one of us. Apli kundali hai tyancha hatat. All the giant databases, Make My Trip, cheaptickets.com, yatra.com, it is linked with Google. We all make use of Gmail and most of our bank accounts, they are linked with Gmail. So Google literally knows everything about every one of us. So Purvi, gone are the days when students, they used to ask their teachers and kids, they used to ask their parents and the peers, they used to ask their colleagues. Today for all of us, our best friend is google.com. And as a result of that, gone are the days जेव्हा आपण सत्यनारायण पूजा करून नातेवाईकांना बोलवायचो. आता वी आर इन अन एरा ऑफ ई सत्यनारायण अँड दॅट इज वॉट इज नोन टू अस एज एस ई ओ, सर्च इंजिन ऑप्टिमायझेशन. अँड इव्हन कॅज्युअल सर्फिंग अँड कॅज्युअल क्लिक्स दॅट वी डू ऑन इंटरनेट, इट एंड्स अप गिविंग गुगल ह्यूज अमाऊंट ऑफ रेव्हेन्यूज. लास्ट 3 महिन्यांचा जर आपण विचार केला तर गुगल इज 5.1 times बिगर दॅन मायक्रोसॉफ्ट अँड 4.3 times बिगर दॅन ॲपल. And the only company which is bigger and better than Google is Amazon, but it's because of their retail chain. And if we take that away, Google is bigger and better than Amazon as well. So you have to be futuristic. You have to really understand the technological trends, and only then we'll be able to carve out a niche for our own selves. The fourth mantra is R, research. And research is not something that happens only in NASA. It's about being curious. It's about asking questions. Again, अनफॉर्च्युनेटली आपली शिक्षण पद्धती अशी आहे की पाठ करा आणि परीक्षेत तेच लिहा आणि मार्क्स मिळवा. देर इज व्हेरी लिटल स्कोप फ्रॉम फर्स्ट टू 12th स्टँडर्ड अबाउट बीइंग क्युरियस अँड अबाउट बीइंग इन्क्विझिटिव्ह. सो दीज 4 years ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग यू शूड आस्क ॲज मेनी क्वेश्चन्स ॲज यू लाईक. नो क्वेश्चन इज अ स्टुपिड क्वेश्चन अँड एव्हरी क्वेश्चन हॅज इट्स ओन स्वीट पोटेन्शियल. आपण किती ब्लाइंडेड झालेलो आहोत, हाऊ इनसेन्सिटिव्ह वी हॅव गॉन to this art of asking questions. I'm going to share just a couple of teasers with you. Have you ever thought about this? Why do we get odd number of days in the month of February? 28, and if we are in leap year, suddenly 29. Why? What could be the reason? I work in the field of machine learning, and we write algorithms which are iterative. and we say iteration after iteration, the algorithms, they march on towards the optimum solution. So there is this popular saying in English, we say march on, we never say January on, do we? So let's play a game. Let March be the first month of our new calendar system, and then we have April and May, and it continues. And as we are in the seventh month, in Sanskrit, seven is Sapta, and we get September out of it. And eight is Ashta, and we get October. And nine is Navam, and we get November. And 10 is Dasham, and we get December out of it. And now January becomes the 11th month, and February now becomes the 12th and the last month of this new calendar system. So what could be the reason? Not just you and me, bunch of us in this room, but the entire universe, the entire globe follows this logically illogical looking calendar system where January is the first month of our calendar. Why? And Britishers left, and without thinking about the consequences, we have accepted so many things. Why Mumbai is still the capital of Maharashtra state? If we go a little down south, earlier Mysore was our capital, and Britishers, they moved it to Bangalore. Bangalore is the only city on this green planet which does not have river next to it. For any city to prosper, you have to have river next to it. And there are five states who are fighting over Kaveri issue right now. Who is going to take how much percentage of water? Bangalore, no river next to it. Huge problem with water. Pune is so fortunate that we have confluence of two rivers, Mura and Mutha. कदाचित म्हणूनच पुणेकरांना मुळातूनच अडमुठे म्हणतात की काय कोण असतो आय डोंट नो बट दॅट्स जस्ट ऑन द लाइट एंड वेन बट वी हॅव टू हॅव थिंकिंग कपॅबिलिटी अँड दॅट्स वेअर द फोर्थ मंत्र आर रिसर्च कम्स इन टू पिक्चर अँड द फिफ्थ अँड द लास्ट वन इज एस दॅट इज स्किलिंग वी हॅव शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम स्केलिंग टू स्किलिंग पूर्वी टी सी एस विच इज नॉट टी कॉफी स्नॅक्स इट्स टाटा कन्सल्टन्सी सर्व्हिसेस अँड इन्फोसिस ऑल द बिग कंपनीज त्या यायच्या आणि 500, 600, 700 मुलांच्या बॅचेस उचलायच्या दोज डेज आर गॉन अगेन थँक्स टू इंडस्ट्री 4.0 वी आर इन अन एरा ऑफ स्किलिंग सो नॉलेजच्या बरोबरच इट्स व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट टू हॅव स्किल सेट्स गावस्कर असं म्हणायचं आहे एखादा बॅट्समन जर चांगला खेळत नसेल तर गिव्ह हिम सम टाइम ही विल बी बॅक इन द फॉर्म आफ्टर ऑल क्लास इज परमनंट अँड फॉर्म इज टेम्पररी सो इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ एज्युकेशन नॉलेज इज परमनंट सो रिसर्च इज गोइंग टू गिव्ह यू नॉलेज अँड स्किल सेट्स आर टेम्पररी बट दे आर एक्स्ट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर्म आवश्यक आहे जर चांगला स्कोअर करायचा असेल तर अँड पर्टिक्युलरली इन टुडेज एरा द टेक्नॉलॉजी हॅज बिकम सो ट्रान्झियंट अँड दॅट्स वेअर ऑटोनॉमस इन्स्टिट्यूशन्स दे आर टेकिंग हेल्प फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री पार्टनर्स ह्यूज अमाऊंट ऑफ स्किलिंग हॅज बीन हॅपनिंग अँड इट्स अ व्हेरी व्हेरी पॉझिटिव्ह साईन सो पी डी एफ आर अँड एस आय होप दीज फाईव्ह थिंग्स विल हेल्प यू decide the correct branch for you and become excellent engineers in your pathways. I honestly believe that most of the inventions and discoveries were accidental in their nature. And the accidents are bound to happen, but one has to walk the path first. And for walking the path, one has to see the path. I believe that these kinds of discussions, deliberations, brainstorming sessions will help you see your path, you'll start walking the path, and many sweet technological accidents are then bound to happen. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, sir, for sharing informative and motivational words. Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker is Mr. Aditya Bhandari, who is Executive Director of Global Education Limited, an alumnus of University of Southampton, UK, with specialization in marketing. Mr. Bhandari is young and dynamic person. He was also associated with JSE Steel, Bangur Cement, ITC and Philco Group. I request Mr. Aditya to navigate the audience about soft skill and also for aptitude development.
I request volunteers by that time to collect the questions from the audience so that we can start question answer.
Thanks a lot. Good evening, everyone. Dignitaries present on and off the dais, principals, vice principals, students, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would propose my warm wishes for the success of this GHR Career Connect program. I'm only mostly going to focus on what we at Global are doing to enhance skills which will help you for your placements. Once you start with your colleges, it's very important for you to map out and goal and make a goal so that you can accordingly work and skill yourself during those 4 years of engineering. Being an educational service provider company, I'm well aware with the facts that training plays a very important and vital role in shaping and careers for students. It is a dream of every engineering student to get placed in a top organization. You all would know about EQ versus IQ. Your intelligence can give you a job, but how to sustain and grow in your professional career is what we teach and inculcate amongst young budding engineers. Gone are those days when your degree alone can get you a job. Even if you might have a higher pointer, you might find it difficult to find the right job for yourself. Out of 100 plus skills that we at Global are training, we offer our trainers are primarily focusing on technical skills, communication skills, aptitude skills, foreign languages and others. At present, placement has become a very challenging task for both students and for colleges. Training of students and equipping them with life skills has become an important responsibility for all institutions. Along with technical expertise, development of a holistic personality is also very necessary. We train the teachers, students, and we skill them in a lot of skills like artificial intelligence, machine learning, power sector skills, embedded systems, 3D printing, AutoCAD, soft skills, ethics, etc. We have built, we have set up a fully fledged operation cell with best trainers to meet the current industry requirement. It's good to know a fully fledged system is already in place at Risoni, which is really helping engineers to achieve their goals. Setting up goals in life is really important. Dreams only come true if genuine efforts are put in. All colleges should have ensured that students become employable, which is very important at this hour. Global Education Limited, which is a NSE-based listed company, has more than 100 trainers who are constantly working to achieve the same with along 10,000 plus students. We are also skilling in Cambridge English communications, IELTS and other building trainings. We have partnered with the best assessment companies in India to actually analyze the skill gap which needs to be focused on. Lastly, from my experience, I would like to point out some really important things that every student should focus on while they are in the college to enhance the chance of getting a good job and most importantly, sustaining a job. Firstly, which is very important, your communication skills. Secondly, the problem solving ability, which includes aptitude training. Three, you should all know how to be a team player. Four, leadership skills is really important. Five, working with passion, which we've already been discussing from quite a lot of time. Being honest, and most importantly, openness to learning, which has to be a trend, and you should be really open for gaining all the knowledge you can at any given point in your life. That's all. Probably wishing you all the best for your future endeavors. I would like to specially thank Risoni Group of Institutions, Mr. Sunil Risoni, he's the chairman, Shreyas Risoni, executive director, Mr. Ajit Tatia, he's the trustee director, RGI, for organizing such a great seminar, which is helping students, prospective students to choose their career. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Aditya. Zindagi ki asli udaan abhi baki hai. Zindagi ke kai imtihan abhi baki hai. अभी तो नापी है मुट्ठी भर जमीन हमने अभी तो सारा आसमान बाकी है. दिस इज फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव रिसेंटली पास आउट फ्रॉम यू नो 12th. सो ऑल्दो वी हैव करियर काउंसलिंग यू नो प्रेजेंटेशन बट विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू टेक यू टू क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन. सो इफ यू हैव पास ऑन यू नो योर क्वेरीज टू द वॉलंटियर्स आई विल अप्रिशिएट. कैन यू रेज योर हैंड्स प्लीज इफ यू हैव स्पेसिफिक क्वेरी. You have no queries, then I have. Okay, so
सर मला आहुजा सरांना विचारायचंय. मला म्हणजे इंटरेस्ट कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंगलाच आहे. जसं तुमच्या मित्राचा मुलगा होता तसं काही नाही. कोडिंग वगैरे मी बायफोकल सब्जेक्ट घेतला होता आणि मला 195 त्यामध्ये स्कोर झाले. तर कोडिंग वगैरेमध्ये इंटरेस्ट आहे पण मी असं बरेच. आता माझी बहीण ENTC इंजिनिअरिंगच्या स्टडींगमध्ये ING अजून आहेच म्हणजे सगळ्या थर्ड इयरला आहे. तर त्यांच्यामध्ये बऱ्याच चर्चा चाललेल्या असतात की कम्प्युटर इंजिनियर्सला जॉब्स तर मिळतात पण कोर कंपनीजमध्ये मिळत नाहीत. मग त्यांचे पगार वाढ होत नाही. तर असं काही आहे का की बाकीच्यांचे जे म्हणजे मेकॅनिकल वगैरेंच्या सॅलरीज नंतर वाढत जातात तसे कम्प्युटर इंजिनियर्सच्या हळूहळू वाढतात?
नाही, इट्स अ व्हेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. You want to create a company?
I will.
You will, okay. So why are you worried about the package?
Sir, I am not having that much financial support by my family, so I will earn.
So, you think IT companies don't give you a good package?
They will give, but I'm talking about other branches and competing with them.
No, your question is whether core companies give more package or IT companies give more package.
He wants to know, sir, that if he is pursuing computer engineering, so in that case he will not be placed in core companies. And then how he can have a better package
in core company?
Yes.
Sir, I will choose. Shall I choose mechanical or computer?
Okay,
or
you want to have a confusion between the core branch or computer science. Okay. So everybody is running after computer. So yes. So
I'll tell you the COEP part of it, and then I will hand over to Mr. Hari.
Sir, just one minute. I just wanted to say I'm electronics engineer. I did my MTech and PhD in the area which is related to civil engineering, which is intelligent transportation. My all publications are in computer science and engineering, and now I am working in biomedical and artificial intelligence. So really what all speakers have said, branch doesn't matter. Everybody has emphasized follow your passion. So whether you are in a core branch, whether you are in computer science, that's my take, sir, please.
The best of companies come to COEP, Microsoft, Amazon, Google, Facebook. They all start with package of 25 lakhs to 30 lakhs per annum. Our graduate who just comes out at the end of 4 years starts with a salary of 25 lakhs per year. As far as IT or computer branch is concerned. Core branches also, the package is almost in the same range. Company called Ibarra from Japan, they give a package of 39 lakhs, starting salary 39 lakhs a year. So it is all about, all of us have told you that how you think and how you present yourself. Right? So if you are going to be an engineer who is always thinking, I think our difficulty is that most of us have stopped thinking, you know, because up to class 12 we have been told if this is the problem, it belongs to this type of integration, this is the type of category of integration, this is how you have to solve it. That is how we have been brought up today up to class 12. We have to move beyond that. We have to start thinking. Dr. Abhyankar said, you know, you have to be very, very curious. Ask every time. So whether it is, I'm a mechanical engineer, so I would ask you to become a mechanical engineer. But pursue your passion in computer engineering. You can do that by taking up a minors in computer engineering. I'm not a computer engineer, but I would say that I know almost all the languages that are there.
Professor Ahuja and Professor Parole both are mechanical engineers and they know computer science probably better than computer science engineer. Professor Kakde, who is a professor, well-known professor of computer science and now IIIT director, is basically electrical engineer. So, am I correct, sir? I guess, yes. So, every one of us are multidisciplinary. Professor Aditya Abhyankar is basically from electronics and telecommunication engineer. and then he's a well-known professor in India and abroad for compression and civil engineering in all domains. For that purpose, he is dean for interdisciplinary domain. So that's it. I mean, I guess so, there are a number of questions.
Ma'am, I just one more thing. One of our students, he took up production engineering. It's a sandwich course, 1 year in the industry, 3 years in the college at COEP. After doing a 4 year course, he stayed back at COEP for 1 year. After getting his degree in production engineering, he was at COEP for 1 year. He took all courses in computer engineering because he liked computer engineering, but he didn't get admission. We gave him additional credits and grade sheets for those courses. He went abroad, he did his master's in computer engineering, he did his PhD in computer engineering, but his basic degree is production engineering.
So that's
where your passion drives you, so that is how it is.
Madam, I think I should have a word
here. Sir, there are a number of questions.
Just for his sake.
Okay. But then, we can have one question, one panelist, so probably we'll be able to serve.
But
okay.
The people who are not offering packages are talking about packages. We are the one offering packages. So maybe I need to answer this question.
Okay.
So the simple truth of life is that you have to understand what is your prime mover. Don't chase money. You chase your passion and work, money will follow. Trust me on this.
So that's everyone's take, that follow your passion. Before we move to second question, let me know, everybody is aspiring for engineering. So do you know the meaning of engineering? Who can define engineer? Let's have some question answer, but before your questions can be entertained, just answer what you mean by engineer. Anybody? So please, yeah. Other than you, so probably if we can follow some rule, so anybody else? 300 plus. Would be engineers, please see at least Wikipedia. So what's that? One, yeah, please. They are the creators of everything that is around us, like everything. Like even this chair or the screen or the lights. Engineers are creators basically. Okay, so one who does not create is not an engineer. No, we can't say that. Even if they do not have a degree, basically they are engineers, if they are creators. Okay, so let's clap for her. So basically, she wanted to say, one who is creator is an engineer.
Ma'am, she is saying God is engineer. the biggest creator, yes.
Let's move to second question. So many new universities are coming up. Parents are confused. Should we stick to old one or think about new one? I think many of them have answered, but what you need to look into. And Professor Abhinkar probably has said specifically, you visit the institutions, visit their labs, understand the curriculum. Until unless you see the curriculum which is industry relevant, which is based on latest technologies, you cannot say, yeah, I mean, you should not confirm your admission. But still, I would like to pass on this question to Kakde sir.
Now, gone are the days of differentiating between new and old universities. As we have suggested, have a look at the curriculum of that university, whether it is in line with the current industry trends or not. Look at the faculty strength of that university, look at what type of research going on in that university, and then take a decision. So it should be an informed decision. Let's not go by perception. Normally, we go by perception. XYZ college is good. Who has decided it? No, seniors are telling us, and this is a societal perception. Let's not go by that. We have gone over the days of going by perception. Now, Government of India has introduced National Institutional Ranking Framework, in which, based on the data submitted, the ranking the institutions. You can use NRF ranking as one of the parameters, because all these things are taken into account while deciding the ranks of the institutions. So these are some of the mechanisms that you can make use of to decide which university you should choose. Okay?
So above all, sir said, in addition to that, everybody, it's a world of, you know, if we look at India, so Startup India, Make in India, Skill-based India. If you have to think differently, look at what kind of ecosystem is there in the campus for innovations and students' engagement. If you look into the institution's website, you will get all information how the students' engagement takes place in that particular campus. And it starts with innovation. Think about, I mean, why? If you think about a helicopter, so why helicopter has tail backside? I mean, why can't you imagine? Because everybody has said the same thing and I'm repeating the same. You know? So why we cannot imagine the fan to be at the bottom? Why the helicopter has fan to be on top? So if you learn why, where, how, you should choose that college. Look at who does most of the innovations, who teaches in what way. Are you going to read the book? Are the teachers, as Professor Kakade said, they are going to relate the same thing, or they are going to make you creative? Select that college. With this, we move to the second question.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, quickly, engineering is a professional course and you are going to become professionals and you should look at this question very professionally. So in my opinion, two things are extremely important. A, whether the institute you are going to go to, is it going to open your mind? If it is going to close your mind, then no fun doing that. If the institute is going to open your mind, then that's the institute you should go to. If you look at the age map of the Nobel laureates from science and technology, all of them, they received these awards at a very young age. Vis-a-vis age map of Nobel laureates in arts fraternity. So crazy things happen at a very young age. You are going to invest tangible assets with the likes of money of your parents, but more so, you are also going to invest intangible assets, your time, your energy. The next 4 years are going to be the maximum productive years of your professional career. So you should really look for an institute that will open up your mind. And second, this education does not come for free. So by the end of the fourth year, either you should have a good job in your hand or you should be able to become an entrepreneur. So you should, in my opinion, select an institute that gives you an opportunity to take one of these pathways.
Thank you, Aditya. So the next question is from Ajinkya. I want to know about mechatronic engineering. This branch is available in very few colleges. How one should go with this branch and with the available courses? So, Professor Kadole, please.
Good question. Yes, I am also aware that there are now only few institutions who are having this branch as such, mechatronics. Few years back, this was a sort of a very crazy sort of thing, and many of the institutions were having this kind of either courses or branch. But now, as everybody has agreed, these barriers of having different branches and this kind of thing is going to get up, and all you have to have sort of a common sort of a platform wherein the multidisciplinary approach or interdisciplinary approach is going to be there. So in all the institutions now, you can say, as he was also talking, that you can have, you can satisfy these things by having major and minor, those kind of subjects. Then you can have different open electives, and these requirements can be satisfied by even having the mechanical branch, and then along with that you can select the subjects as an open elective or as a minor, and this requirement of mechatronics that can be satisfied. So there is no need as such of having a specialized mechatronics line. This is what I.
So, the next question goes, how to know, this I pass on to Hari sir, how to know and or how to find where my passion lies?
Who is this person? Can you stand up? Or you ask me such a difficult question? Who is this? Can you stand up, please?
So,
don't want to stand up, is it? Okay. So, you know, where your passion lies, you will understand is a gut feel. Like I said, in our times, you know, if you don't take science, you are gone case. It was then commerce, then arts. Today, trust me, we had somebody in my college, along with engineering, he used to move around in a Kolhapuri chappal, jhola, and he did some LIC ke insurance policies. Hum sab uska mazak udate the. Bolta nahi, LIC ka insurance policy bechne acha lagta. Along with that, today if you look at money, this boy who asked about money, he was a multi-crore-pati. Multi-crore. But he didn't bother about who thought what. He just thought ki this is my passion, period. Again and again I maintain, it is known to you, each one of you, in the deepest recesses of your being. My only request to parents is that don't thrust what you think the person should be onto them. That's all my request. It is known to each one of you. But that passion is going to be recognized by you yourselves. Like I spoke of so many examples, I gave Bumrah, I gave Stephen Hawking. All these people were written off at one point of time. So it is not it is about you recognizing the strength within. He spoke of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda only said one thing, that we are all, you know, sheep, we are all lion in sheep's clothing. Because of the way our parents are, our teachers are, pura lion andar hai, lekin pura sheep bana ke rakha hai. Like, throw away that clothing, you will find out what your passion is, where you are. There is enough on the plate for any and every profession today. So, in that, in engineering, don't worry ki where you are, which stream, what. Is it AI? Is it IoT? Are you to be in Google, Microsoft, Amazon? Don't bother. Chase your passion, period. All of us have said that. But you know, Warren Buffett said one thing. He said, money is not important. But I had made enough money before I said that. Aisa nahi hai. Chase your passion, money will chase you. All the best.
To be passionate, you have to believe in yourself. To be passionate, you have to believe in yourself. If you have belief in yourself, you will be passionate.
Thank you, sir. And before we move to last question, anybody wanted to ask? If you are not written, please stand up. I mean, the volunteers would have. Okay. So, can you pass on the mic, please? So, that's good networking. Yeah. And yes.
Good evening, sir. The engineer I have met, I said that I am going for engineering, but they said don't go for engineering, it's worse. So, is there any dark side after 4 years?
So, who would like to answer? Okay, Aditya.
So,
yes.
So, probably the person you met, he is not passionate about engineering. As simple as that. His heart doesn't lie in engineering. Like that young girl said, engineers are creators and we end up creating so many interesting things. The spirit of engineering is about solving interesting problems, and that is so much very essential for benefit of society at large. So how can engineering be worse or boring? It's just that you have to figure out whether your heart lies there or not. If not, sure, engineering could be very boring for you. Then you should not do it. But if your heart lies there, then sure. I mean, engineering is such a fantastic thing that can happen to you. That will transform you.
Thank you, sir.
The next question
I'll
is...
I'll just add to that, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There is nothing like a dark side. It is only your mindset, your attitude that makes you think like that. And the second thing that I want to tell you, which most autonomous institutes practice and also being done at CAAP, we have courses on liberal learning. So we have many students who are passionate about painting, about photography, about singing. They want to do something creative, but their parents said, no, tula engineer vaiche. So they end up at CAAP, but we have liberal learning courses where they are, you know, we empower them to, you know, go beyond engineering. And today, engineering is not confined only to science and mathematics and, you know, applied engineering or technology. It is also they call arts. You know, arts is an important part of engineering. So it's not STEM anymore. Science, it's not STEM. It's STEAM, which has arts into engineering. So most autonomous institutes provide for that curriculum where you can also do what you wanted to do besides engineering.
Thank you, sir.
I'll take a quick minute.
So,
Very quick minute, but for his benefit.
Yes, sir.
Beta, darkness is not the opposite of light. It is the absence of light. So, I have Sanjay Adao, he's a deputy collector. I quote people so that it becomes easier. He was at St. Joseph's, Pune, at Kaki. There was one student who broke all records in that school because they never produced anybody who got second class. He said there was one boy who got second class and the whole class, they cursed him. Yeah, tumhari wajah se pura school ka track record kharab ho gaya. That guy, I will not name him, he has bettered everybody else because he thought like you. He said, because these people told me that you are into darkness, ye light nahi hai, ye nahi hai. He said, that is what created so much of magic within me, or the power that somebody was saying that you have to understand it is all within you. And he moved out. So, darkness is not the opposite of light, it is the absence of light. And surely that will come into your system.
Thank you, Hari sir. The next question is, suppose if a student is in engineering college and if he is good at one or the other co-curricular activities, so rather than education, so does the college helps? Yes. Just now, Professor Ahuja has given the answer and I would like to add to the same. Almost 20-30 clubs which do exist in the autonomous colleges, including Raisuni. You want to become guitarist, if you want to have horse riding, if you want to become musician, if you want to enter into research, if you want to have, you know, entrepreneurship, anything. So everything is available within campus, including photography, foreign languages. You name the skill, you name the activity, and you will find that club do exist in the institution. Like from laughing club, yoga, pranayama, photography, swimming, guitar, every club do exist. And if you have passion into research, so there is a full-fledged research cell which do, you know, support you for making your proof of concept, prototype, and will provide you seed money for your all endeavors. Coming to the next question, yes sir.
Going to add a few things to that. The VNIT is also having similar kind of clubs and this thing, and not only this technical clubs, but we are also having clubs like Prayas, where students are engaged in social activities and they are helping the society. Many of our students are going to different schools of corporations. They are going there, they are teaching to those students for competitive exams, then they are going for blood donations, collecting the sheets. And not only that, we are also organizing the social conferences called Renaissance. And this has been done at VNIT for the first time, and which is followed by BITS Pilani and IIT Kharagpur and those kind of. So there is ample opportunity for the students for doing other kind of things also. Then there are clubs in most of the institutions we encourage for their innovations and these things, like Center of Innovations, where you can get the funding for doing your this, you can pre-incubation, incubations and startups and those kind of things. So there are a lot of scope. So you should not feel that you have to be good in engineering, but otherwise also you have got a lot of scope for doing many other things.
So yes, Aditya. Yes. Aditya wanted to add.
Agreed, but your first liking and priority has to be engineering. This is icing on the cake, पण पहिले तो केक चांगला बेक झाला पाहिजे. And that is engineering. If you are a good engineer, you can look at arts from the engineer's perspective. मी तुला गंमत सांगतो, मी अमेरिकेला गेलो आणि माझा स्वयंपाकच चांगला व्हायचा नाही. सो मी एकदा आईला फ्रस्ट्रेट होऊन फोन केला, तिला म्हणलं जमतच नाही आहे ग. तर ती म्हणली तू इंजिनियर आहेस, तू स्वयंपाकाकडे इंजिनियर सारखं बघ. आणि मग मी म्हणलं अरे फोडणी खूप इंटरेस्टिंग आहे. ती जेव्हा त्या तेलाची बुयन्सी त्या मोरीच्या बुयन्सीच्या थोडी वर जाते तेव्हाच तडका बसणार. सो देन माय इंजिनिअरिंग ब्रेन स्टार्टेड वर्किंग आणि आता मला उत्तम स्वयंपाक येतो.
सो इंजिनिअर Now, dear panelists, it's rapid fire round because we are lagging time, and then we have toppers as well waiting for us to, their felicitation. So, quick question to Director COEP. For admissions at COEP, does the JEE mains score is valid?
Not for COEP.
Not for COEP. Now, which computer language is good for freshers? Although I don't agree with Professor Kakade, but still I'd like to him to answer. I will say Python and we will say C. But still, I want Professor Kakade to endorse.
Definitely. One should begin with C programming.
Okay. So, let's see.
Discussing in Raisun that day.
Yes, sir.
That there has to be in first semester you can have C, and then in the next semester.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And then next is, should I do IT engineering or computer science and engineering? Who will like to answer in one? So, Professor Karatkar, I would like to answer you.
So, computer science and engineering or IT?
Computer science and IT, both. Programs are, people think that both programs are almost one and the same. But there is a slight difference what we can say. Computer engineering deals with the hardware and software design and operations of the computer. For example, if you consider the software aspects, then the operating system comes, then the different software platforms, assembler, linkers, their design, that is traced. And at a micro level, also, controller designs or the multiplier designs, that type of what we can say, the topics are included in computer. But IT has a little bit different what we can say. The management of the, what we can say, the data and all that, some management related flavor is given to the IT. Of course, for the first basic, what we can say, 2 years, the things are almost parallel, but later the differentiation starts. The person who want to work in the managerial aspects with the background of the computer, he or she may prefer the IT. Otherwise, if you want to make a career in computer, go for the computer engineering. That is my advice.
Thank you so much. And dear students, you can look at, you know, the various options which are there. Because of lack of time, we are not able to show you the presentation. If I want to pursue my career in robotics, what should I do? Which should be the ideal branch? Again, the answer is same from Professor Parole, but still I want him to answer. Although mechatronics you have answered, sir. But he wanted to say he wanted to make the career in robotics. So which branch is good?
I suppose mechanical is one of the best branch for doing your career in robotics.
I would say all the branches. Robotics has everything. Yeah. Computer science, electronics, mechanical, materials.
I fully agree with you. I'm not contradicting, but that mechanical branch, I was...
And even telecommunication.
With the electives like this, like electronics,
yes,
and computer vision and those kind of, that will definitely make him better in doing robotics in further his
yes,
graduation.
Yes, every branch offers the course in robotics. Next question is to Professor Ahuja. Is it correct that every year the rule for getting admissions in engineering college is changing?
So rules are changing, but not drastically. Now this year...
the second question in the same is, please help us to understand the admission process in short.
Yeah, like last year, there would be rounds of engineering, and first round is as per the reservation policy. And more importantly, in the second round, let's say in case of minority institutions, that reservation is removed. You know, it's all the quota is transferred to open category. You know, so. Probably one can take advantage of the second and third round. So if you have a preferred choice of branch, don't give up. Keep continuing with that branch till the last round. You never know, you might get your choice of institute and branch at that point in time. But definitely second round onwards, there are more options available. More so in minority institutions, you know, so you can grab those opportunities.
So like Raisoni is minority and then admissions gets open in second round for everyone. Last question is, cap is, does it cap is for all the colleges, including autonomous institutes in the state and also in Pune.
Yes, yes. CAP, the central admission process, is affected by the Commissionerate of Admissions, Government of Maharashtra. The entire admission process is controlled by the Director of Technical Education, Government of Maharashtra, and it is centralized, common for all autonomous, non-autonomous affiliated colleges. It's the same process. And you have to just fill up one online form and give your choices, whatever choices that you want. And once you are in the process, you continue to be in the process, and that is how but your first choice, if you get, then you are out of the process. So that is how it is.
And also, in addition to CAP, there are colleges who will have institute quota as well. So 20% quota is institute quota. So in case you are not, you feel that the college is good and you are not able to get in seat in CAP quota, so you can approach the institutes with the institute quota as well. And
at CAP there is no institute
quota. Yes, sir. Right. In government colleges there is no institute quota, but then in private colleges you can get in 20% institute quota as well. So with this, we have, there must be many questions, but then if you can pass on those questions to our volunteers, probably after this program is over, we'll surely get back to you. Please write your email address and mobile number on the same slip, and within 2 hours, our volunteers will get back to you with your queries, and the answer would be perfect. And two lines again from me before I sign off. And we'll start with the felicitation of 12th class students who have come from distant places and different schools to be here. This is for you students. Har pal pe tera hi naam hoga. Har pal pe tera hi naam hoga. Tere har kadam pe duniya ka salam hoga. Mushkilon ka samna himmat se karna hai mere dost. Dekhna ek din waqt bhi tera gulam hoga. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, dignitaries, for answering all the queries. It is rightly said that next to excellence is appreciation of it. We, at Rysori Group of Institution, believes in fostering a motivating environment for the students so that they always get encouraged to reach peak of the success. A person who is appreciated will do more than what is expected. So, as a gesture of appreciation and love, we are felicitating toppers of various renowned schools and junior colleges of Pune who have come up with flying colors in their HSC examination. Apart from this, we are also offering scholarship under SGR Knowledge Foundation, which is called as Merit Scholarship. Under this scholarship, students, those who have scored the percentage between 80 to 89, will get 5% concession in first year fees. And those who have scored above 90 will get 10% concession in first year fees. And if they maintain their percentile above 9 in further years, they will be benefited with the same rewards for remaining years too. I would now like to request Mr. Ajit Tatia to please do the honors. I request Tejas Musare from Modern College of Arts, Science and Commerce to please come forward. He has scored 90.3% in HSC examination. Vidula Vilas Magdum from Abhasar Garware College. Vishwesh Vivek Pujari from Abhasar Garware College. Vidula has scored 93.85 and Vishwesh has scored 91.23%. Vidula Vilas Magdum, she has scored 93.85% from Abhasar Garware College. Vishwesh Vivek Pujari, he has scored 91.23% from Abhasar Garware College. Naseem Tambat.
Nasim has scored 87.23%. She is from HGM Azam College of Education. Yashpin Iqbal Muzawar, he has scored 88.31%. Farkanda Sheikh, she has scored 87.38% from the Pune College of Arts, Science and Commerce. Thank you, sir. A huge round of applause for all the toppers. Thank you, sir. May I now request Sri Shreyas sir to please do the honors. I would like to request Brahmadin Azibar Merchant from Choksi High School and Junior College. He has scored 93.85%. And Vaishnavi Ratnakar Ghadge, she has scored 91.38%. Alisha Dilwar Mulani. Sejal Sachin Shivarkar. Vaishnavi Manjare, Sonupriya Bimle, congratulations to all the toppers. Thank you, sir. I would now like to request Mr. Aditya Bhandari to do the honors. I call upon the stage Pratiksha Fulari. She has scored 83.63% from Siagar Junior College. I guess she is not here. Okay, her mother is here. Please welcome. Congratulations, ma'am. Sakshi Srimandikar. She has scored 77% from Maharshi Karve Junior College. Hriday KP from Kendriya Vidyalay Army Area, Pune. Darshan Khope, he has scored 89.57%. Darshan Khope. Vinod Munde, Suraj Kevande. Heartiest congratulations to all the toppers. I would like to request you to take the maximum benefit of the scholarship provided by the college. Now I request Dr. R.D. Kararkar, Principal GHR IT Pune, to kindly propose the formal vote of thanks.
Good evening. Good evening, dignitaries on the dais of the dais. All the good things must come to end, and we are at the end of this program. At the outset, I must congratulate the parents and students who got brilliant success in the 12th examination. On behalf of the Raisoni Group of Institutions, we congratulate you. I must thank the students and parents for attending the GHR Connect program, especially on the weekend days. Now today is the Saturday, and on the Saturday eve, you have spared your valuable time, very precious and prime time, that is the evening time, for designing the career of your wards. It itself shows that you are keen interest in the design or making the career of your students, and this assures the quality of the education also. I must congratulate the parent and students. Today we have the knowledgeable and experienced resource persons who have not only thrown the light on engineering admission process, but also explored the domains like importance of autonomous colleges, present technologies, related career options, industrial 4.0 revolutions, and related job opportunities. The issues discussed will definitely benefit the student to decide the branch and colleges. My sincere thanks to Dr. Ahuja sir, Dr. Kakade, Dr. Padole, Dr. Aditya Abhyankar, and Mr. Hari Ishwaran for the advice and mentoring the students and parents. Raisoni Group always takes the initiative and organizes such programs for the benefit of the stakeholders. We are thankful to Mr. Sunil Raisoni, Chairman of the RGI, Mrs. Shobha Raisoni, Trustee of RGI, Mr. Shreyas Raisoni, Executive Director RGI, and Mr. Ajit Tatiya, Director RGI Pune Campus. I must thank Mr. Aditya Bhandari, Executive Director, Global Education Limited, for timely support to carry out our program activity. Our special thanks are due to Directorate of Technical Education for allowing us to host this program. I must thank Dr. Nandanwar sir, who permitted us the association with DTE. We are grateful to all media persons and press for giving the pre-program publicity, and we hope the similar post-program publicity also. My thanks are due to media also. The team of Raisoni Group of Institutions, directors, principals have been functioning consistently from last 3 weeks for making the program successful. I am thankful to Dr. Preeti Bajaj, Director GHRC, Dr. Palewar, Director GHR-CEM, Mr. Ajit Singhvi, Mr. Nagendra Singh, CEO GHR Career Foundation, CA Mr. Nitesh Sakleja, and Mr. Ashwin Pandey, Director HR, for gracing this occasion and for making this program successful. We thank to all core committee members of GHR Connect, deputy directors, vice principals, heads of the department, faculty, non-teaching staff, and students, volunteers, for the successful organization of this program. We assure you that in future also, Raisoni Group will organize the similar programs for the benefit of the students and parents. We request you to submit your valuable feedback on the feedback link, which is given in your registration kit. At the bottom of the program schedule, feedback link is given. Please go to link and give your valuable feedback. That will be useful for organizing the next program. Now with this, once again, I thankful to all, and I wish a great success in engineering curriculum for all the wards and students. Thank you.
Before we end up, a few certificates are remained. I would like to invite them to receive the certificates. Sakshi Shirmandikar, is she here? Mrudaya KP. Aditya sir, please do the honors. Darshan Khape. Mr. Vinod Munde. Suraj, Mr. Suraj Ghevande. Thank you, sir. आम्हाला पूर्ण विश्वास आहे की आजचा कार्यक्रम आपल्या सर्वांना आवडला असेल व आपल्यासाठी उपयुक्त ठरला असेल. मित्रांनो, आपण रायसोनी समूहाशी एका ऋणानुबंधात बांधल्या गेल्या आहात. आम्ही आपल्या सर्वांना आपल्या करिअर संबंधी काही माहिती पाहिजे असल्यास ती आवश्यक करू. नाऊ आय रिक्वेस्ट ऑल टू काइंडली स्टँड फॉर द नॅशनल अँथम.